You're watching the 2016 Motel 6 Cactus Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. From Morgantown to Phoenix, from Tempe to Phoenix, West Virginia, Arizona State, as we conclude bowl season from the Valley of the Sun. West Virginia, Arizona State, little Big 12, Pac-12 action coming your way from Phoenix, Arizona. And a pleasant good evening, everybody. Dave D alongside my All-American from the University of Georgia and NFL offensive lineman, Matt Stinchcomb. Glad you could be with us as we wrap up bowl season right here. And what a way to do it with Arizona State and West Virginia, two high-powered programs. This should be a lot of fun tonight.
You look at both of these teams, they started to peak right at the end of the season. Didn't end the way they wanted to, so a lot of motivation to play their best football here in this bowl game tonight.
Let's start with West Virginia. This is a team that used to throw it around the football field all the time, but they've kind of adjusted things here in 2015 and gone to the running game.
Yeah, some of that started back in 2013. Coach Holgorsen recognized they needed to be more physical on the ground. Hadn't had a 1,000-yard rusher since 2010, back when he was at Oklahoma State. But Wendell Smallwood really emerged as a tackle-to-tackle runner. Very physical, was able to feel some of their counter and power schemes that Dana Holgorsen introduced into this offense. They run the ball 61% of the time. You never thought you would say that about this type of an offense.
Well, when you talk about Arizona State, Ty Graham loves his defense, and it's hard to say defense is fun, but watching this group can be fun.
Well, if you like aggressive defenses, yeah, then this one's for you. They're gonna get after you all game long. Seems like they blitz every snap, and they come from everywhere. They'll blitz from the perimeter, from the linebacking position, and very rarely do they do it in line, meaning they're typically coupling their blitzes with line stunts. Makes it very difficult from a protection standpoint. And offensively, a lot of negative yards created by this aggressive defense that Keith Patterson employs. Watch this game. Arizona State does a great job of penetrating the offensive backfield and generating those negative plays.
We are in Chase Field, home of the Arizona Diamondbacks. They have turned this diamond into a gridiron, at least for one night. They actually played this game in this field way back in 2005, but they bring it back for this year. West Virginia, Arizona State. Sun Devils win the toss. They defer, so West Virginia will get the football first. Arizona State comes in 6-6. They went 4-5 in the Pac-12. West Virginia 7-5. They went 4-5 in the Big 12. Zane Gonzalez will kick it off, and he'll sail it through the end zone out to the 25-yard line. Third member of our team down on the sidelines. Let's join her now, Casey Smith.
Hey, Dave. Arizona State's defensive coordinator Keith Patterson held the same position at West Virginia just two seasons ago. He's very familiar with Dana Holgorsen's system and the personnel because most of these guys that are on this team were there when he was coaching. But his situation tonight is even more unique because he spent a lot of time coaching with current West Virginia defensive coordinator Tony Gibson. Coach Patterson said he spent a little bit more time in Arizona State's offensive meeting rooms for bowl preparation. He thinks his two cents are going to help in tonight's game.
A lot of tie-ins between these coaching staffs. We'll get into that as this game unfolds. First play from scrimmage. Skylar Howard, pass complete, goes to Jordan Thompson, the senior out of Katy, Texas, with his 29th grab of the year. Picks up 11 as you look at the junior from Fort Worth, Texas. Been kind of an up-and-down season. Quickly to the line. Goes to the wide side of the field. Pass is caught out to the 40-yard line. Russell Shell, the running back, the junior, with his 15th catch. West Virginia loves to go hurry up.
And you mentioned it, Dave. Skylar Howard a little bit up and down this year. Some of it has been because he got rocked early on their Big 12 schedule, got sacked 7 times by Oklahoma. It's part of the reason why West Virginia had to shift to the run game.
After the play was over, personal foul, offense, number one. 15-yard penalty, second down.
Boy, Shelton Gibson was the receiver on the far side of the field. Skylar Howard made a beeline for Shelton right after that play. He obviously saw what happened and had a word or two for his wide receiver. And that'll back him up all the way back to the 25-yard line.
You mentioned it, Dave. One of the things West Virginia wants to do, they want to be able to play with tempo, play with pace. You open up with a nice pass to Jordan Thompson. You back it up with a completion to Russell Shell. The last thing you want is to be backing up because of a personal foul, dig yourself a hole, and get off schedule.
This West Virginia offense averaging 33 points a game, sixth in the Big 12. 235 a game on the ground, second in their conference, 16th in the country. Out of that pistol formation and a lot of movement up front. This is what these coaches were telling us in our meetings that they were worried about. Lengthy layoffs.
We get it so much with bowl preparation. Happens quickly, get a little bit rusty, but especially as facing an aggressive defense.
False start. Offense, number 57. 5-yard penalty, second down.
That's big left guard Adam Pankey. He's going to do a good bit of pulling in some of the power and counter schemes that Dana Holgorsen has incorporated into their offense. We mentioned how they want to run the football more. Adam Pankey's going to need to have a big game. What they don't want is go backwards.
Howard coming near side. Pass is caught at midfield. Down inside the 30-yard line goes White for a huge pickup. Just his 12th catch of the year.
This was the concern for Arizona State coming into this game. They knew that West Virginia was going to take some shots. In this year so far, this Arizona State defense, they've allowed 77 plays of 20 yards or more. That's a big one.
Incomplete. Caron White, younger brother, a former West Virginia wide receiver, seventh pick in the NFL draft. Kevin White looking a little bit like his brother on that one. But there are some of those numbers. Allowed 21 passes over 40 yards. That is the most in the FBS in the last 5 years. We talk about their aggressiveness, but that's the other side of that equation.
And the mentality of the Arizona State coaching staff is that they're willing to take the good with the bad. The risk reward of being regressive is hanging out your corners in man coverage.
Howard, wide side, wide open. Gibson out of bounds at the 11-yard line. Pickup of 16.
Shelton Gibson is the big play man. We've already seen Caron White with the big one. You see the respect, though, a big cushion for Shelton Gibson to make an easy completion underneath the coverage.
They had a second down and 26 and pick up 53 yards.
You see that, the aggressiveness and also the confidence of Skylar Howard. Nice protection so far. He's managed the pocket well.
Smallwood, his first carry. See where they spot that. Probably right at the line of scrimmage. It'll be second down and 10. Just inside the 11-yard line.
You can see the penetration early. Arizona State not scared to commit defenders to the line of scrimmage. You don't want your running back making moves in his own backfield, but that's what Smallwood had to do.
He'll fake it to Smallwood. Go to the end zone. Flag down. Looking for shorts. Brown on the coverage.
Dakiel Shorts. He's working against Quishy Brown, and you see Brown with that right hand sneaking in. You see him right and left hand before the ball arrived while it was in the air, and then just got his head around late after he'd made the contact. You see the aggressive play calling, especially on the heels. Those back-to-back penalties off the personal foul and the false start.
There's no foul on the play. Third down.
Boy, Dana Holgorsen is about to explode if he hadn't already. He is chewing on our officials on this near sideline.
I don't really understand it either. I don't know why the flag comes out if it wasn't there. It's a pass interference, a subjective call. And it looked to me like Quishy Brown was clearly early. Watch his right and left hand into the chest of Shorts.
How was that not? How do you pick that flag up?
That was a good flag. I don't know why it got pulled.
Third down. Here's Smallwood. Big hole. Cuts it back at the 5. Hit at the 4 and falls down at the 3. Picks up 6. And now you're looking at fourth down at about 2 yards.
8-6. The decision time, of course. Smallwood. Just an inside zone play. You can see Dana Holgorsen still losing his mind. Rightfully so. The side judge came in a little bit late. Had a little bit more to add on that previous penalty on a PI. But it was interesting that that flag would come out and then somehow be waved off. On
the
field goal
attempt. The only thing I can think of is they thought maybe it was an uncatchable ball. I'm just saying it was catchable, but I'm thinking maybe that was in the discussion.
Right.
Josh Lambert to attempt the 21-yard field goal from the far hash, and he will split the uprights. Lambert now 19 out of 26 on the season, and that will give West Virginia the early lead. Dana Holgorsen won at 7. He was about to have a... West Virginia with a nice opening drive. They had a couple of penalties in that opening drive that set up a second down and 23, but they're 26, and they had a 53-yard home run ball to Caron White. Then it looked like they were going to be set up first and goal after what appeared to be a pass interference call in the end zone. That the flag was picked up, had to settle for a field goal. They'll take the 3. Now West Virginia about to kick off. Nick O'Toole, Tim White, the electrifying track star, right at the goal line. Already has a 100-yard return to his credit. Has a little bit of running room to the 35, to the 45, and knocked out of bounds. Well, we're lucky enough to have a referee, Tim O'Day, with us up here in our broadcast position. Let's go back to that pass interference call a moment ago, Tim, and break down the dynamics of this for us.
All right, Dave, well, there's 8 guys on the field, and each one, 8 officials on the field. Every official has a responsibility. On that particular play, the side judge had the key responsibility for that receiver. So the back judge had the flag. The side judge thought he had something different. They came together, they talked about it, and they decided to pick the flag up.
Who makes that ultimate call on decide to pick it up?
It's a crew decision. It all comes down to who saw what.
Bergovici, first pass. Incomplete. Was that behind the line of scrimmage? They'll say incomplete. Boy, that was close. Looking for DJ Foster on that first attempt. It'll be second down.
See Bercovici, and he just slings it right out there. Wow, I'll tell you what. It's as if the flight of that ball traveled right along the 40-yard line. It was ruled a forward pass. So trying to get the football to DJ Foster, a guy we're going to talk about a lot tonight. He is prolific offensively for Arizona State, not only as a receiver, but also as a rusher. Spent some of his time at running back as well.
Second down and 10. Bercovici will throw on the run, throws a bullet. Lucian couldn't handle it, but Bercovici, what a year he's had. 3,400 yards passing, 26 touchdowns, averaging about 286 a game through the year, 11th in the FBS in completions. What a way to go out as a senior.
No question. And, you know, he's been playing under duress this season as well. As a rough start in their opener versus Texas A&M. Sacked 9 times. Knocked around a little bit because of some of their inexperience at the tackle positions.
He's 85 passing yards tonight for 5,000 in his career. Third down and 10. Here comes a sellout by West Virginia. Tim White turned the corner and stumbled and didn't get his eyes up in time, and it's a 3 and out for the Sun Devils.
West Virginia is an excellent defense, probably one of the best defenses that Arizona State will have seen all season long. Statistically, a fine third down unit, allowing only 32% conversions. That's good for 13th in the country. They do an excellent job, not only in third downs, but forcing 3 and outs. That's a quick turnaround to get the West Virginia offense back on the football field.
Matt Hawk will punt it away. Third in the Pac-12 at average, 43 and change. A very short kick that will hit at the 26 and bounce out of bounds. Well, the national championship is coming up. The stage has been set for the college football playoff. The national championship game presented by AT&T. Heisman Trophy winner Derrick Henry carries the Crimson Tide as they face off against Deshaun Watson and the undefeated Clemson Tigers. Tune in Monday, January 11th at 8:30 on ESPN, also streaming live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app. Boy, we are just down the road from Glendale. That's where it all is going to happen a week from Monday. Cannot wait. Inside handoff goes to Shell. Nowhere to go. Might have lost a couple of yards.
See, coming out of that pile, Antonio Longino. Excellent linebacker. Plays on the line of scrimmage quite a bit. He's effectively a down lineman. He plays in that devil position. You look at Arizona State, they're so aggressive. The names of their positions are aggressive. There's a devil, there's a tiger, there's a bandit, there's a spur. Longino's one of the best ones among them.
They'll go with Shell again. Out over the 40, he'll have the first down. Russell Shell, the junior, picks up 15.
Watch this twist, and they're gonna hit him right where they twisted. And this is what happens sometimes when you're swapping assignments on the defensive front. You can catch him just right and bust a big one.
Howard over the middle. Caron White with another big catch. Boy, they were telling us this week this young man has really blossomed in this bowl practice the last few weeks. Picks up 26 more.
Coming into the game, only 11 receptions. A young guy and a young receiving core. But you can see the bowl practice and the balance of the season really coming of age in this game.
Flags down all over the field. Tayshawn Smallwood.
Offside. Defense, number 90, with contact. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Looked like he got a, might have gotten a Lucas to pop up in his stance, but Smallwood made the first move.
You can see him definitely in the neutral zone. The ball is snapped by Tyler Orlowski. He actually made contact, it looked like, with Adam Pankey. Makes it nice and easy for the officials to get the call.
Boy, another play fake. Quick throw, pass caught, batted in the air, and caught! The Keel Shorts comes up with the football. Sheldon Gibson got popped. And it went off Adams of Arizona State.
And Shelton Gibson, the assist. With a nice bounce pass to Shorts.
And now, Shell is thrown for a loss. Take one more look at that.
You see this shot. Look at Chad Adams come up and knock Gibson loose. You see the ball bounce off of Salamo Fiso. Dekeel Shorts coming up there. Just in proximity. What a lucky turn of events that time for West Virginia. But what set it up was the pass protection. Great job by the Mountaineers up front. And also the running backs got involved that time, kept Skylar Howard clean, gave him time to deliver that football downfield.
Boy, Adams really put a lick on Gibson. To the end zone, just out of the reach of Shell. Boy, how about West Virginia? Everybody's been talking about how they run the football, run the football, run the football. They have come out here firing it through the air.
Well, and when they've tried to run the football, they popped a few. But you can see it. That's one of their MOs, of course, coming into this game. They want to be able to throw off a play action. It helps that offensive front to where you're not in obvious passing downs, especially versus a defense that you know is going to pressure you no matter what you do, line up from formation standpoint or from a play call standpoint. Makes sense to have that run element in there as a threat.
Howard, 7 of 9, 128 through the air, trying to add to it here over the middle. Just out of the reach of White.
Maybe a little bit too amped up that time. That's two overthrows in a row by Skylar Howard. One on the fade to Russell Shell, this time wide open. Had White underneath. They lined up in a stacked formation to his right. He was open all the way on that route. Just an overthrow by Howard. Two missed opportunities, really, by West Virginia in the red zone now. One due to the waved off pass interference flag. Now a couple overthrows.
31-yard field goal. Josh Lambert hit from 21 a moment ago. This from the near hash. Nick O'Toole will hold it. Good clean snap. Kick is on the way, and it is right through the uprights. Lambert now 2 out of 2. 20 out of 27. Don't see this every day. off the hands of Gibson. But there's Shorts for the easy reception. Sets up the field goal, 6-0 West Virginia. 42-7 was the final score in that one. Way back in 1979. How about that?
These teams don't see each other very often, but these two coaching staffs, they couldn't know each other any better. Boy, there's a ton of overlap.
Dana Holgorsen. Fifth year now, West Virginia. Todd Graham now in his fourth year at Arizona State. Kickoff, touchback. Let's go down to Casey.
Well, Dave, Arizona State head coach Todd Graham told me this week that senior quarterback Mike Birkovici has essentially been a co-offensive coordinator during bowl preparation as they welcome a new offensive coordinator, Chip Lindsey. He said that Mike's understanding of this offense and his leadership has been a huge aspect of this team. And down here on the sidelines, guys, he's going up to every single position group asking what they saw on that last offensive series and wanting to get it fixed before they went back out on the field.
Yeah, not a good opening drive for Arizona State. Three and out. They threw the ball each possession there, and they didn't look in sync, at least to start the game.
Drop right out of the gate to DJ Foster and got him off to a bad start.
They'll go on the ground here. Mario Richard picks up a couple of yards. This is an offense this year that has put together 34 points a game, sixth in the conference. But talking to Todd Graham, very disappointed. You know, this is defense. He likes to be in the 40s.
Yeah, and he kind of allocates some of that issues to their lack of turnovers. They like the quick change. They like the big momentum shifts. They were neutral in turnover margin this year at zero.
They'll go with Richard again. He'll pick up a yard this time, and now you're looking at third down and 7.
See the challenge, too, that they're faced with. An excellent linebacking core by West Virginia. Jared Barber on the previous play, Nick Kwiatkowski, back-to-back plays. That's their best level of their defense, is right there in the second among their linebackers. You see the substitutions now coming in for their cheetah package. Speed guys, Edward Muldrow the third, you'll see him right here, number 20. He's got some speed. Expect a blitz.
And there he goes. Pass gets out quickly, but well shy of the first down. It'll be fourth down and about 3.5. Lucian makes the catch, number 58 for him, the senior transfer from UCLA. And now another punting opportunity for Arizona State. So 2 3-and-outs to start this one.
You can see, you know, without their offensive coordinator, Mike Norvell, now the head coach at Memphis, Birkovici over there consulting with Chip Lindsey, who's serving as the quarterback coach, the new offensive coordinator, trying to get acclimated with this new roster, but also trying to figure out this West Virginia defense here tonight.
Our side judge running in about 40 yards to talk to our referee. Jeff Cervinski, our crew out of the Big Ten today. Possible clock issues.
The play clock, they're probably looking to reset the play clock. You see him come running in there.
Game clock operator, please reset the game clock to 7:45. Play clock will be set to 25 seconds, and both will start. Am I ready for play?
So Matt Hawk will punt it away. Good clean snap. High hop taken by KJ Dillon. We'll backtrack a little bit. Trying to get the edge. That didn't work very well. Drop back at the 24-yard line. Well, everything on ESPN is now streaming live on the ESPN app. Download the app now. Good look at Chase Field, home to the Arizona Diamondbacks. Tonight, home to the Motel 6 Cactus Bowl.
They did a great job converting this venue, didn't they? I mean, we were commenting on that. If we're not for a little bit of the infield, you'd never know that they played baseball in this venue.
Seats a little over 40,000 in this configuration, and as you might imagine, a lot of Sun Devil fans inside Chase Field. They'll go handoff. Wendell Smallwood, nowhere to run. And right back to the line of scrimmage. Christian Sam chases him out of bounds. 92 tackles on the season now for Sam to take the team lead in that department.
Christian Sam very active from his linebacking position. We mentioned both of these defenses excellent at that spot.
Howard gets out of trouble to the 30 and out of bounds. That'll set up a third down at about 3.5. Lloyd Carrington forces him out of bounds, but give Howard 6 yards on the run.
Tell you what, Dave, I like the way Skylar Howard has handled this game so far. When the pressure has started to get there, and it hasn't very often, frankly, West Virginia doing a good job in their protection schemes, but when it has, he's managed the pocket, and that time opportunistic on the scramble.
So far, 6 out of 10 for 128 yards through the air. Looking at a third down and 3.5. Elijah Wellman in the game at running back now. Play clock at 3. They get the snap off. That one is picked off. Fisho down the sideline, and he is dropped at the 23-yard line. Salomo Fisho with his first interception of the season.
Here's Fiso right here in the middle. And they changed the coverage late. Chad Adams was lined up to the field side, dropped all the way back. Looked like pressure was going to be coming from the field. It ended up coming from the boundary, and Fiso, from his linebacking position, dropped right underneath that pass.
And now the West Virginia defense will be tested. Short field for the Sun Devils. Balazs in at running back. Will fake it. Berkovici a little bit high on the throw. And he is now 1 for 5 to start this game.
That time just a little bit beyond the outstretched hands. Cody Cole from his tight end position. Not a target often seen in their passing game. Berkovici hasn't been able to get into a rhythm. Tough on this quick change.
Come on.
They'll hand it off. Balazs picks up 5. Down to the 17-yard line. Kyle Rose sticks his nose in there to make the tackle for West Virginia.
West Virginia with that 3-down front. Kyle Rose anchors it. He's a zero nose tackle, meaning he's lined up head up of the center. He's got to control the middle of that line of scrimmage. Excellent job that time on the inside run defense by big number 93.
Boy, 3rd down and 5 now. Flag down. Berkovici bump fakes. Hits Lucian. Picks up 12. That'll be a 1st down, but let's wait for this flag.
Illegal formation. Offense, number 57. 5-yard penalty, 3rd down.
They're saying Evan Goodman was lined up too far back, trying to get back in pass protection. Sometimes these tackles cheat a little bit in their stance. If they don't see their helmet break the midline of that adjacent guard, a lot of times you'll see it. You see him right here. What they're saying is by alignment, he's lined up off the line of scrimmage. You have to have 7 lined up along the LOS.
So now it's 3rd down and 10. Balazs will shift to the right. They'll hand it off. Sweep coming near side. Well shy of the 1st down. Run out of bounds right around the 20-yard line by Askew Henry. Only a gain of 2, and here comes the Arizona State field goal unit. Zane Gonzalez, who's coming off a game where he went 6 out of 6 in the field goal department against Cal, which tied a Pac-12 record for field goals in a game. This one will be a 37-yard attempt from the near hash mark. Gonzalez, 22 out of 29 on the year. Add one more to those totals. Makes it look easy. So the interception sets up Arizona State in good field position. Their 14th interception of the season. And Arizona State has cut into this West Virginia lead. It's now 6-3 with 5:06 to go in the opening quarter.
You mark that down, though, as a win by that West Virginia defense, able to keep Arizona State out of the end zone after that big momentum shifter. We mentioned Todd Graham lamenting the fact that they didn't get nearly as many turnovers as they're used to generating. In this game, they get one. Defense generates a short field off the interception. But West Virginia able to bow their necks after Salamo Fiso, number 58, was able to give them excellent field position to work with.
Fiso should have had two interceptions in this game.
You're right. That's true. And one for that tip to shorts in the red zone going the other way for West Virginia.
Gibson. So Gonzalez will kick it away for the Sun Devils. A line drive kick that will go out of bounds. So West Virginia will have excellent field position to start this drive.
Kick out of bounds. Kicking team number 5. Ball will be placed at the 35-yard line. First down and 10.
Kickoff coverage, not a strength for Arizona State. They've only seen 18 kickoff returns all season long. Probably a good thing, too. West Virginia very dangerous in their kick return game. I don't know if we'll see one because Gonzalez has either banged them all the way to the back of the end zone, that time sneaking out of bounds. Either way, good field position, as you mentioned, Dave, to start off this drive for West Virginia. And offensively, they've only stopped once they've reached the red zone.
They'll go with Wellman. Big hole out to midfield. A gain of 15. They'll actually spot it to 48, so give him 17.
They motioned Wendell Smallwood out of the backfield. You'd think that they would be thinking pass, get it to him. He's an excellent receiver. Instead, they pass it off, hand it off to Wellman.
Well, welcome to Phoenix, where West Virginia is racking up some yards as Shelton Gibson takes it inside the red zone. West Virginia marching it up and down the field. Dave Neal, Matt Stinchco, Casey Smith with you as we wrap up bowl season from the Motel 6 Cactus Bowl inside Chase Field, home to the Diamondbacks. But tonight, it's home to West Virginia. Arizona State, little Big 12, Pac-12 action. Continuing right here on ESPN, West Virginia with a couple of field goals. They haven't been able to get it in the end zone. Arizona State with an interception a moment ago, led to a field goal, a 6-3 game here in the opening quarter. But West Virginia has put together an impressive offensive display here in the opening half. They are closing in on 200 yards of offense. Arizona State with just 14 yards of offense. It has been all Mountaineers.
It really has. Arizona State, that attacking style defense, but they've also given up big plays, and we've seen those big plays here tonight already. Caron White, Shelton Gibson with big plays in the receiving game. And also we've seen a couple of nice runs by Wendell Smallwood and even Elijah Wellman from his fullback position on the ground.
Smallwood averaging 120 yards a game on the ground. Gets the handoff here, cuts it back. He's to the 10 and stopped there. It'll be third down and a couple coming up. Smallwood has been their man.
This is SportsCenter.
1,447 yards on the ground, 6.5 yards per carry. Number 13 in the country in total rush yards. West Virginia going quick. Howard to the corner of the end zone. Incomplete, looking for Shelton Gibson. Lloyd Carrington on the coverage for Arizona State.
Another fade route. We've seen two to the right side of the formation, this same end zone. That time that ball too far inside. Didn't really give Shelton Gibson much of a chance. He's got great range from a target standpoint. But Lloyd Carrington, number eight, in his corner position, was better positioned to make a play on that ball. Third red zone trip, resulting in a field goal after big plays getting this West Virginia offense down the field.
Josh Lambert back on the field. He's hit from 21, from 31. This one from 27. Far hash. Kick is on the way. And he splits him again. It is a 9-3 Mountaineer lead. 3:13 to go. Opening quarter from Phoenix, Arizona. Some time with some of the parents, children's there. And I'll tell you what, it's just been a great week here for both these teams. They've enjoyed all the festivities of weather, as you might imagine. It's been fantastic. Of course, last night, Fiesta Bowl going on. Notre Dame and Ohio State saw all those fans. Ohio State fans were quite happy. A lot of smiles for the Buckeyes. Not so much from the Fighting Irish side of things. Not quite as much. And of course, a week from Monday will be the national championship game. Well, those of you just joining us, we've had a lot of offense, but not a lot of points on the board. Dave Neal, Matt Stinchcomb, so glad you could join us as we wrap up this bowl season, and what a way to do it with these two explosive teams. West Virginia has been coming in here. We talked about how well they run the football, but they have been throwing the football extremely well behind Skylar Howard.
Yeah, opening possession, facing a second 26, a hit Caron White, and then no pass interference on what looked to be early contact, trying to find Nikhil Shorts, resulted in another field goal. Arizona State defense holding up once West Virginia gets to the red zone, but we've seen some big plays given up already in this game.
Bergafici coming near side. DJ Foster. Here's a young man that certainly is a highlight reel waiting to happen. Trying to finish out his career at Arizona State on a high note. He is 49 rushing yards away from becoming the first and only player in the history of this game to have 2,400 yards rushing, 2,400 yards receiving. We will keep you honest on that number throughout the night. Demario Richard loses a couple of yards, and that's the story so far for this Arizona State team. They just can't get any momentum going.
You know, in addition to turnovers, the youth or the inexperience at tackle and the issues at receiver, one of the things that Todd Graham mentioned was negative yardage plays on offense. That time, Shaq Pettaway able to get into the offensive backfield, create a negative yardage play. Arizona State has never found a rhythm offensively in this game.
Third down and five. Three-man front. West Virginia looking like they're going to bring some heat, and they do so. Six coming. Pass is caught. They're going to say it is a reception at the 49-yard line. Lucien making a big-time play for the fifth-year senior transfer from UCLA.
Working against backup Rick Rumpf, Darryl Worley, an all Big 12 corner out of this game for academic reasons. They had all 11 defenders within 10 yards of the line of scrimmage. You see Rick Rumpf. Those DBs are always quick to help the officials out. I want to see if Lucien got at least 1 foot down. It's hard to tell from that look. He certainly controlled the football. Both hands on it. You see it there, that left foot. I don't know if his heel came down out of bounds or not. This might give us a better look at it. And of course, one of the coaches on the sidelines perfectly positioned to obscure it. Yeah, it looks to me like his toe even is out of bounds. That left foot, you see it there as it came down initially, regardless of if the heel tapped or not. Be surprised if that one doesn't ultimately get overturned. And once again, for Arizona State, we've seen a couple of times when they had excellent field position off the interception, couldn't capitalize. And this time, Devin Lucien, who's had a phenomenal end to his career, last three games, 453 receiving yards. You see him go up for this football. Watch that left foot. Right there, you know, to me, it's hard to tell from this angle. We had another look at it was actually facing the receiver, and it looked to me like his left foot, even the toe, had come down out of bounds.
What a find for Arizona State to pick up Devin Lucien. Had 58 catches in his entire four-year career at UCLA. Just kind of got bogged down over there. Graduated, wanted to come here. Obviously, this was an opportunity. Come back closer to home. His mom was battling breast cancer. He found a home
here. After further review, the ruling on the field stands as called. Completed catch, first down and 10.
Other than that one look, it looked as if he got that foot down inbounds. Officials had a chance to take a look at it. That's a big play that Arizona State was looking for. Lucien spent a lot of time on shorter routes, 10 yards and in. They only average about 8 yards in the air for completions. They don't throw the football downfield as much. And in the back end of the season, Lucien was discovered as a downfield threat.
59 catches this year, 58 in his entire UCLA career. Berkovici steps up in the pocket. Well, that could have been picked off. Looking for DJ Foster, but Terrell Chestnut was going for the big hit instead of the football. Otherwise, he'd have had the pick.
Yeah, Terrell Chestnut, he's waiting on this one. I mean, it's almost as if it was thrown to him. And you're exactly right. He's looking for the blow-up shot on DJ Foster. Ball, it looks like it even glanced off his hands.
Hit him right between the 1 and the 6. Berkovici wide side. Pass caught to the West Virginia 48-yard line. Gain of 3 on the play. So that'll be a 3rd and 7 coming up.
As we mentioned, this game all season long, West Virginia excellent on 3rd downs. They brought pressure on previous obvious pass downs, as we do here.
Incomplete, no flags on the play.
We mentioned the familiarity of these two coaching staffs. Tony Gibson, defensive coordinator for West Virginia. He spent time coaching with Todd Graham. 2 different occasions, was on his staff at Pitt. He was also one of his position coaches when he was coordinating a defense for Rich Rodriguez at West Virginia. Todd Graham, familiar, actually helped develop West Virginia's defensive philosophy. A lot of cover 3.
For West Virginia.
Hawk punts it away. High kick. Bounces into the end zone. Out to the 20-yard line. With that, time to get an update. Let's go to Adnan Virk in the studio. Hey, Adnan.
Hello, Matt.
Gorgeous couple of days here out in the Valley of the Sun. Arizona State making the 15-20-minute drive over from Tempe. Sun Devil Stadium being renovated. They're in phase 2 of a 3-phase project. It's going to be a gorgeous facility when they get that wrapped up. Skylar Howard has plenty of time. Makes a nice throw out over the 40. Pass is caught by Jordan Thompson, the senior from Katy, Texas, with his 30th grab of the year. Picks up 32 more yards.
West Virginia continuing to find wide open spaces over top of the Arizona State defenders. That time, Marcus Ball caught in no man's land for the Sun Devils.
Russell Shell, maybe a yard. West Virginia's had a really good tempo to their offense tonight.
Yeah, they've clicked. They found ways to sequence plays back to back. And they've mixed it up quite a bit as well. We've seen a couple of runs pop. It's not Wendell Smallwood. We've seen Russell Shell. Both those running backs getting looks in the passing game as well. But already, Shelton Gibson, Karan White stretching the field in the passing game.
The numbers are staggering. West Virginia has put up 236 yards of offense. Arizona State with only 42. But the big board says it's a pretty close ball game. 9-3 our score after 15 minutes of play in the 2016 Motel 6 Cactus Bowl. West Virginia comes into this game 7-5, 4-5 in conference play. Arizona State at 6-6. But West Virginia so far through one quarter of play has been the dominant team so far, but the lead only six. Second down and 10 for the Mountaineers. Skylar Howard, pressure comes, gets out of trouble. That's a little bit of room to run, stumbles forward, picks up about a yard and a half. Tayshawn Smallwood forced him out of that pocket, gets a couple of yards.
Big third down for West Virginia, and mainly because it's the first one that they faced. It wasn't in the red zone. They're 0 for 4 on third downs despite the offensive numbers they put up.
Howard stands in the pocket over the middle, passes dropped. A little bit behind Garon White. Solomon Means on the coverage.
Attacking defense. Bodies around. Skylar Howard still delivered a catchable ball. Garon White could have, should have come up with that catch. Covered by Solomon Means from his safety position, just enough to disrupt that catch.
Nick O'Toole, sixth in the FBS, averaging 45.7 yards a punt. This one will bounce into the end zone. Well, Todd Graham has had some issues a couple of times today with not only his players, but coaches as well.
That's special teams coach Sean Slocum. And what they're saying is, I think you've done a tremendous job most of the night. I would just like to point out that I would like to defend a field goal with 10 men on the field if possible. You see that 11th guy running off the field. Todd Graham taking exception to that. Still made it up between the uprights.
Barrage, nowhere to run. I think this West Virginia defense, maybe one of the more unsung units in the country this year. They have gotten better and better the last couple of years, and this year they are second in the Big 12 in points allowed. Total defense, second in the Big 12, giving up just 386 yards a game. Impressive numbers from this Tony Kitson group. Big number, plus 11 in turnover margin. Boy, what a sharp throw. Lucy, it makes the grab, but that might have been the best throw of the night from Bercovici.
Beautiful throw from Bercovici. West Virginia only brings three, dropped eight in the coverage.
Oh.
Drops that one right over the head of Rick Rump, who we've mentioned playing in the absence of Darryl Worley, and Gerard Harper late coming over from his safety position.
Bercovici steps up in the pocket. And that one right through the hands of Terrell Chestnut. Had one hit him right between the numbers. Didn't see that coming. That one he read all the way and just couldn't hold on.
That time, ill-advised throw from Bercovici. West Virginia, you see, dropping three. They've got that safety net of having three deep. Time, Askew Henry almost came up with the pick.
On second down, they'll run it with Kalen Balazs, the sophomore out of Payton, Colorado, will pick up three. Arian Howard, the nose tackle, will get credit for that stop. 300-pound junior.
So far in this game, Dave, West Virginia's defensive front has done an excellent job of controlling the line of scrimmage in the ground game. We've seen West Virginia pop a couple of nice runs. Arizona State, they've got some nice rushers as well. Haven't been able to get the ground game going at all in this one.
Pressure comes, Bercovici is hammered. No flags on the play. Lucian almost came up with that catch.
Tony Gibson dials up some pressure from the perimeter. K.J. Dillon coming and Kwiatkowski. And again, going after Rick Rump. Lucian almost juggled that ball into a reception. Kwiatkowski, all Big 12 linebacker, leveled Mike Bercovici. Shots like those are the ones that get into the helmet of quarterbacks. They remember.
Hawks punt, fair catch called for by K.J. Dillon. He'll let it bounce, and it'll be down around the 5-yard line. West Virginia's backed up, but they lead it by six. 12:48 to go, second quarter. Scholarship funds. Good look at Chase Field, home of the Arizona Diamondbacks, but they made the transformation. For the Motel 6 Cactus Bowl, Dave Neal, Matt Stinchcomb, Casey Smith down on the sidelines. Glad you're staying up with us as we wrap up bowl season. Only one college football game left. That's the national championship game a week from Monday. Just down the road in Glendale, Arizona. Here's Wendell Smallwood. Flag comes out. Right about the line of scrimmage, Christian Sam on the tackle.
Holding, offense, number 88, half the distance to the goal, first down.
Tight end Cody Clay.
Working against Marcus Ball. He's in there. Second, third string guys in there now. You see Cody Clay grabbing that jersey too much, right there on the edge. It's an easy call. Of course, digging a hole. We saw this in the first possession by West Virginia, able to overcome it. Drive the football down the field, but you never want to open up a position like that. Dig yourself a hole.
So first and 14. Howard in the end zone. He'll hand it off. Smallwood fights his way out to the nine. Let's go get an update from Casey.
Well, Dave, despite their lead, West Virginia head coach Dana Holgorsen expressing his frustration down here on the sidelines that this offense has been in the red zone three times and they can't get it past the goal line. Quarterback Skyler Howard telling his offense, we have to get in the end zone, guys. Calm down. Let's do what we do.
Well, Howard is just hammered as he lets that pass go. Ron White can't hold on to it, and Howard just got hit right in the chops. Oh.
Mentioned the hole on Marcus Ball. Look at that. Well, I'll tell you what, that's a bruised sternum waiting to happen. I'll tell you what, too. Marcus Ball, you talk about targeting, it's not just the head or neck area, but it's also the crown of the helmet. Marcus Ball lowered his head, lowered the boom. It wasn't in the head or neck area, but it was certainly the crown right to his chest.
Todd Grantham.
I'm out. Arizona State, their first of the half.
Wants a timeout. Take a look as Todd Graham takes that timeout. Gives us another look at that that collision. Marcus Ball coming in from his spur position. I tell you what, that is a, you know, there is a launch and there is a crown. And is there a defenseless player issue? Now, we are fortunate to have a referee in the booth with us, Tim O'Day. And, Tim, I'll bring in, and there are some elements there, and I'll just get your thoughts as a referee on that particular play. We all think above-the-shoulder type elements, but what do you think about that particular play there?
You're absolutely right. There's two elements involved with targeting. One is crown of the helmet, and one is defenseless player. The quarterback in this posture is a defenseless player, so you got to think about both of those things in this case.
On third down, they'll go with Smallwood out to the 18-yard line. Looks like he might be about a yard and a half shy. He'll pick up eight. Kareem Orr comes up from his safety position, the freshman All-American with his fourth tackle.
That run was just enough to get the offense some breathing room, punt this football away. Frustration abounds still for the West Virginia offense. See Dana Holgorsen not happy. Obviously the holding penalty to open up that possession deep in their own territory. Dug them a hole and they couldn't overcome it that time.
Coach Holgerson's got to be frustrated with all the offensive yards they put together. Only have 9 points on the board. Nick O'Toole punts it away. Tim White dancing around, still on his feet to the 40-yard line. So a short field to work with for Arizona State. 11:05 to go. Sun Devil offense coming on the field. Berkovici's off to a slow start. Maybe he gets it cranked up when we come back.
The 2016 Motel 6 Cactus Bowl. Brought to you by Quicksilver from Capital One. Earn unlimited 1.5% cash back every purchase, every day. And 13 hours, The Secret Soldiers of Benghazi, in theaters everywhere January 15th.
Well, some of the Arizona State players went to a nice holiday party for the Children's Cancer Network. Raised a little bit of money and some nice chicken fingers in cooperation with Raising Cane's. We're inside Chase Field, home of the Arizona Diamondbacks here in Phoenix, Arizona. West Virginia coming all the way from Morgantown with a 9-3 lead. But great field position here for Arizona State. See what they can do as DJ Foster gets the carry. Only a yard or so and a flag comes in. On the far side, Tim White got tangled up with a defensive player on that far side, and the flag came in rather quickly. It looked like Rick Rump the third.
They've been going after Rump in the passing game, but that time blocking downfield, you're right. He and Tim White, extracurricular there towards the end of the play.
There are two fouls, one on each team. Unsportsmanlike conduct. Offense. Number 12, unsportsmanlike conduct. Defense, number 3, the penalties offset, is the first unsportsmanlike conduct penalty for both players. Second down.
On the top of your screen, you see him there tussling, kind of wrestling. Play's over, whistle's blown, both guys go down. It's real competitive out there, not only in coverage, also when these receivers trying to get blocks on DBs.
Hey, even Max, they both go 5'11", 185.
A couple of NASCAR drivers going at it.
Three-man rush. Over the middle, wide open, pass caught. That'll be a first down for Arizona State. Lucy in with another catch. That one picks up 20 yards.
See Lucy, and he gets right behind the linebackers in front of Rump. Safety comes crashing down, but that's a weakness of the cover three, is the deep middle.
The Mario Richard stuffed by Jared Barber. No gain on the play.
Just hadn't been there all game. Right now, West Virginia have given up a couple of passing plays, but on the ground, they've done an excellent job clogging up the middle, not just at the linebacking position either. Kyle Rose, Christian Brown, they've done a good job of patrolling the line of scrimmage.
Second down, 10. Bergovici. Lucy in, stutter step, reaches for the goal line. Touchdown, Sun Devils. What a night for Devin Lucy.
We said that Arizona State was starting to play their best football. And right now, they brought pressure from K.J. Dillon and Rick Rump, who we seem to mention on just about every other play when Arizona State has the ball. Poor missed tackle. Gerard Harper came over as well from his safety position. And Devin Lucien finally able to breach the goal line for one of these offenses. Great field position was set up by the Arizona State D and the punt return.
One after. Up and good. For all of West Virginia's domination, Arizona State has come in here and taken a lead. Go figure. Crazy game, isn't it? It helps when you have Lucien on your team, though. 10-9, Sun Devils. Thanks, Adnan. There have been so many records set this bowl season. I mean, it's been crazy.
It has. It's been an all-out assault on the record books. We got one that might break here tonight, NCAA, not necessarily a bowl record.
Right.
DJ Foster
needs 49 rushing yards to become the only player in NCAA history with 2,400 rushing yards, 2,400 receiving yards. Arizona State with a one-point lead, and you can credit a lot of that to Devin Lucien, the wide receiver.
Mitchell Darrell Worley's out. Watch Lucien. He's going to run down and underneath, and you'll see the linebackers, they don't drop deeply enough, and you'll see the cover three. So Rump's dropping deep. You've got a safety deep three across, and that's a soft spot in that coverage. But there's enough time for Bercovici to deliver the football downfield. That's available. You look at it just over the top of the linebacker drop and in front of the middle field safety. You see the numbers from Lucien.
484 yards the last two and a half games, five touchdowns, on 22 receptions. That is sick. Russell Shell on the carry picks up four.
New offensive coordinator Chip Lindsey wishes he had another year of Devin Lucien in this offense.
Man.
Or that they discovered what type of threat he could be downfield earlier.
West Virginia has put together 255 yards of offense, but they trail by a point.
It's all come down to red zone execution. That third down abilities. Another 0 for 6 in this game on third downs.
Skyler Howard has taken a couple of really big shots. He stands in the pocket here, going deep down the middle. One-on-one coverage off the fingertips of David Sills, the true freshman. Lloyd Carrington on the coverage, but that was almost a home run.
You mentioned it, singled up on Carrington, and he gets inside in a step, and that's six. Just a bit overthrown. Still probably should have come up with that one for his quarterback, David Sills. And we've seen a couple of overthrows from Skyler Howard. He had two in the red zone on the opening drive. And in that one, Sills is still running if he hits him in stride.
Boy, six up at the line of scrimmage, and they're all coming. Howard feels it, throws it up in the air, looking for Gibson, incomplete.
Tell you what, Quisi Brown got away with a hold. He pulled Shelton Gibson's jersey. It may have looked uncatchable because Shelton Gibson couldn't run upfield.
So the punting team out on the field. Nick O'Toole will punt it away to Tim White. No fair catch call for White. Tripped up at the 35 and holds on to the football. And there's an injured West Virginia player not moving. That looks like Jordan Thompson. Now he tries to get up.
Good news is he is moving a little bit. Certainly in pain down on the field. You see him coming in there late.
It's actually Sharif, two tens on West Virginia. Thompson and Sharif, and that is Sharif that was in on that special teams play.
It came in low, Dave. I wonder if he didn't take a knee to the head. Sometimes you'll see that. And as violent as some of these collisions can look, especially helmet to helmet, the ones that will really rattle you are when you get hit. Yeah. You see his left knee hit the crown of his helmet. And I got to tell you, that'll knock a few cobwebs loose. You're right. Be surprised if we didn't see concussion protocol on the sideline. We've seen him moving, which is encouraging, right after the contact. And I'd be surprised if he didn't get his bell rung really well, which is football speak for concussed.
Says he's ready to go, and he pops up. That is a very good sign. We'll step aside for a moment. Head back to Phoenix right after this. Well, looks like he is going to be okay. Sharif took a knee to the head. He's been attended to on the sidelines by the medical staff, and here's one more look at what happened. And certainly this can be a scary situation, but after a few moments, got up and walked off under his own power.
It was a great play. Came in there, knocked White down quickly. No fair catch. Good to see Kyrie Sharif there on the sideline. Okay. Took him a little bit while to get up off the deck. Getting beat in the head. That'll rattle you pretty good.
Okabichi throws to the wide side of the field. There's DJ Foster, turns the corner. flag comes in at the 40-yard line. Dravon Askew-Henry pops him out of bounds, a pickup of 23.
Got a great block initially from his tight end.
Holding offense, number 12. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
Cody Coles, who sprung him, it looked like. Tim White is who they called the penalty on. Downfield. I guess they're saying that he had a little too much of Rump's jersey.
Boy, he and Rump have gotten to know each other quite well tonight, haven't they?
Haven't they? Seen we've mentioned those two names a lot.
Logo handoff with Kalen Balazs. Tough sled and run the football tonight for Arizona State. A total of 9 rushing yards.
Just can't say enough about it. I mean, it really has been dominating. You're talking about a defensive front. They're playing, it's basically a 3-3. Three big down linemen, 3 linebackers in the box. Good job.
Berkovici knew right where the first down line was. Falls forward. That'll move the chains as he picks up 6 yards.
Not near the run threat that Skylar Howard is. But good job by Berkovici taking advantage of a rush lane right in front of him. As the pressure came around, kind of encircled him in the pocket.
Big collision after a yard. Jared Barber. It's Balazs. Shaq Pettaway gets in there as well.
Shaq Pettaway, the most athletic of the 3 linebackers. Kwiatkowski, the most productive, of course. Got 4 tackles in this game already. Excellent athleticism.
Berkovici on the run. Boy, Dravon Askew-Henry came flying in there to break that pass up at the last moment.
Watch number 6. Drive on this ball. And again, that's the second time we've seen a West Virginia defender. If they're playing the ball in the air, it's a pick. Twice now. Terrell Chestnut earlier in this game went for the blow up instead of the pick.
Trying to set up the screen. They do so. But not a lot to get out of that play at the 45-yard line. A gain of 4. Kyle Rose chases him down. Lucien.
They had the tunnel screen set up. It looked like it was going to go. And Kyle Rose, he and Jared Barber both, great job of covering down. After you pass rush, you see that ball come out, you turn around and try to cover downfield to deny the yardage needed to convert. Another great third down stop by this defense.
This punt will just miss the pylon. That'll be a touchback. Well, it is the final weekend of the NFL regular season tomorrow, so kick off your morning with us right here on ESPN. First at 10 a.m. Eastern, NFL Insider Sunday Edition with injury news and early breaking stories. Then at 11, Sunday NFL Countdown with Wendy Nix, Boomer, and the rest of the boys take you right up to kickoff. It's also streaming live on the ESPN app. So many scenarios to unfold tomorrow. Every game, seems like every game has some impact on somebody's destination.
It's amazing, isn't it? Yeah, we were talking about it last week. It took a 6 tiebreaker somehow to get the Colts into the playoffs. Crazy.
Skylar Howard, wide open over the middle. Pass is caught by White out to the 41-yard line. 21 more yards. Chad Adams on the coverage.
No pressure that time from Arizona State. They just rushed the 4. They left Elijah Wellman in to help protect. We've seen Skylar Howard get grilled. The Spur linebacker Marcus Ball a couple of series ago. Protection able to hold up on that first down play.
Deep down the middle. looking for White. No flags on the play.
Wow. I got to tell you, I don't know how a flag doesn't come out on that. We've already seen this crew throw a flag in the end zone and pick it up for what looked like a sure PI. Trying to get to Caron White. And man, it looks like Lloyd Carrington is grabbing, pulling. It wasn't like they just got tangled up and he went to the ground. It looked like he tried to tackle him and chalked that up as a missed tackle for number 8.
Howard is throwing for 212 yards here in the opening half. Second down and 10. Lofted it up. Gibson, their big play guy, with another big one. Big enough to score 6 for the Mountaineers. 59 yards.
All night long, West Virginia has demonstrated ability to get behind the Arizona State defenders, and especially their corners. You got a middle field safety and man coverage down below. Watch Gibson blow right by Kwesi Brown, and there's no way the safety help is going to get there in time. I wonder why Shelton Gibson, coming into this game, was number 2 in the country in receiving yards per reception. It's big plays like that one, and we've seen them all night.
Point after is up and good. Gibson, 3 catches, 106 tonight. Howard, 271 through the air, averaging 22 yards per catch. Second best number in the FBS. That number's going up, folks. We're in the Valley of the Sun. That is Chase Field. It's the Motel 6 Cactus Bowl. West Virginia up 16-10 over Arizona State, home to the Arizona Diamondbacks. But tonight, it's West Virginia and Arizona State going at it. A little Big 12, Pac-12 action to wrap up bowl season for the 2015-16 bowl season. West Virginia putting on an offensive show tonight. Tim White doing his best to get out of trouble, but can't find any room to run. Well, it's the first big Monday of the season on ESPN, and is it ever big? At 7, North Carolina coming off a win over Georgia Tech, taking on Florida State, who lost to Clemson, so a huge night for Florida State. They don't want to go 0-2 in the ACC. Then at 9, how about Oklahoma taking on Kansas? Both games streaming live on the ESPN app. So Arizona State with 140 yards of offense, only 16 on the ground. Bergovici will throw it near side. Jalen Harvey with some running room out to the 40. He'll pick up 22 yards. Harvey getting some action tonight. Only one catch on the year coming in. Been battling injuries, coming off a bad ankle.
Run pass option. You attack the perimeter off a nice play fake. Wide open was Harvey on the perimeter.
Vici. Lucien. We're going to say he's down. Boy, that was a late whistle. Lucien thought he had a chance to pick up some more yardage, but they'll spot it at the 41.
Well, they're going after Rumpf. I mean, they're going to attack this kid until he gets a stop. Lucien, I tell you what, I don't know where he was down, unless it was his right elbow.
Timeout taken by West Virginia.
Before the ball was snapped, timeout. West Virginia, it's their first of the half, 30 seconds of the length.
A big play. Both these offenses off big plays want to jump the football, get a defense back on their heels. These coaches know it's not a reviewable play. They're not looking for the refs to get another look at it.
Can't say enough. We've talked about what West Virginia's done on the receiving end with Gibson and White, both 100-yard games so far. But Lucien is putting together a night to remember in his final game as an Arizona State wide receiver, 7-for-116 so far.
See, as a physical guy, you know, that catch was probably more representative of what he was doing earlier on in the season, but we saw him make a nice catch over the middle and then on the perimeter, yards after the catch to get into the end zone. Dangerous threat on the other end of these Bercovici passes.
Going to pull the tight end in motion. Bercovici, boy, he has all day to throw. Decides to throw it over to Casey Smith on the sidelines. Come on, Casey. Make a play. You were open.
She'd have been out of bounds, though. Probably not a whole lot of yardage awarded on that one. She could have tapped one of those heels in bounds.
Bercovici tonight, 11 of 21, 164 with a touchdown. Second down and 10. Inside handoff. Mario Richard. He's had a quiet night. 6 yards on the ground for Richard.
Richard carries.
How about 5 carries, 6 yards?
He'd had a good season, 7 times eclipsing the 100-yard mark. Todd Graham really pleased, told us both we'll be impressed with their ground game. Both he and Kalen Balazs, neither one of them able to get going so far in this game.
Third down. On the run. Pass is caught by Harvey. That picks up 7 and will move the chains.
One of the challenges, too. Brought pressure from the edge. K.J. Dillon didn't get there in time. Move the pocket out, flood the routes to the right side of the formation. Nice completion to move the sticks.
There goes Richard inside the 10 down to the 5. Biggest run of the night for the Sun Devils, 22 yards. K.J. Dillon brings him down.
Best run by far, and it's right up the middle. One of the concerns that Tony Gibson had was Arizona State attacking their linebackers. They have 2 bubbles. Both guards are uncovered and can get up on that second level.
Richard again, driving his way down to the 1.
See that big catch by Devin Lucien opening up this series. Even after the timeout, Arizona State able to build on that momentum.
Bercovici trying to get it himself. He'll be stopped shy of the goal line.
Like big Kyle Rose, number 93, somehow wedged his way into the offensive backfield, disrupted that rush. Bercovici was looking to follow DeMario Richard into the end zone. He got upended early.
Richard stopped, might have lost a yard. K.J. Dillon comes up amongst 3 or 4 white jerseys. Kyle Rose was there.
Not enough movement. You see Kwiatkowski and K.J. Dillon. Kwiatkowski spills ball carrier right into the waiting arms of K.J. Dillon. You can see Todd Graham looking to go for it. Dana Holgorsen wants to give his defense enough time to get
timeout.
Set.
West Virginia, their second of the half. 30-second timeout.
4th and goal from the 2.
The red zone has been a friend to neither offense in this game. West Virginia coming into this one. 38 red zone attempts that they allowed all season long. Only 50% of those have resulted in touchdowns. That's an excellent mark coming into this game. Arizona State somewhat pedestrian in this area of the field. And right now, just forcing the 4th and 2 is a good job by the West Virginia defense. It's been on its heels ever since that big catch by Lucy.
Hey, coming up at the half on our Coke Zero halftime report, talk about TCU's historic comeback. Christian Hackenberg declares the SEC represents. 4th down and 2. Todd Graham decides he's going to go for the 3. Zane Gonzalez has made from 37. He is 23 out of 30 on the year. This one is from 19. Out of the hold of Matt Hawk. It is hammered through the uprights. Cuts the West Virginia lead to 3. Good drive, though, by Arizona State. Maybe their best of the night. Arizona State's offense starting to move the football with some success now. The first quarter, not so kind. Second quarter, a little bit better. West Virginia's lead is 3. Berkovici, the senior quarterback. We'll talk about a guy who's taking advantage of his scholarship. He's graduated with his master's last month. Master's in sports law and business. Was the Pac-12 scholar athlete, football scholar athlete of the year.
Sure kid, probably be representing some of his teammates one day.
Not a bad plan. Don't know why more guys don't go down that road.
You got the relationship ready built, right?
Ball will come out to the 25-yard line for West Virginia with 2:53 on the clock.
Dave, we saw in that previous possession after back-to-back stops by the Arizona State defense, an aggressive play calling series with Skylar Howard in the passing game attacking the Sun Devil defense. Amazingly, West Virginia is still 0 for 7 on third downs this entire game. They've done all their work on first and second down.
Let's see what they do on first here. They'll hand it off. Russ Rochelle trying to get the corner. Got a couple of yards. We haven't seen a whole lot of Wendell Smallwood today. 6 carries, 25 yards. Shell now has 6 carries for 17 yards.
Right, the ground game has certainly slowed down here in the second quarter. They were able to pop a couple of nice ones in the first quarter. Sun Devil defense seeing a little bit more of the downfield passing game here in the second.
There's a flag coming in late, right in the middle of the field. Arizona State fans thought there was a hold on that play early. That's a loss of 2.
There is no foul for an illegal man downfield. The ball is caught behind the line of scrimmage. Second down.
I saw what the officials saw. Big number 62, Kyle Bosch. He ran an amazing route. He was about 12 yards downfield. He probably could have picked up the first down. 65 and 62. You'll see him watch him release. He's on the Motel 6 logo all the way downfield. But you can see the ball caught behind the line of scrimmage. Excellent job by the officials getting that one right. They missed a hold, though, on Marcel Lazard at right tackle, JoJo Wicker.
Wide open, it's White. First down at the 40 and a little bit more.
Once again, Skylar Howard doing a good job extending a play and finding Caron White. You see him spill out of the pocket that time, able to keep his eyes downfield. Find White along those plays that can stress the secondary.
White can't hang on to that pass. Caron's having a heck of a game.
Yeah, they're going to get Tashawn Smallwood for a late hit on Skylar Howard. And he nailed him right in the small of his back. Easy call for the official. The white hat standing right there.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense, number 90. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Smallwood coming off the block of Russell Shell. He's trying to come up there and provide some chip help. His running back position, they're just not going to get away with it. You've got two officials in the offensive backfield, the center judge and the referee, and they're watching that quarterback. Already seen a questionable miss. Marcus Ball, his linebacker shot. They're not going to miss the second.
Well, that moves it to the 44-yard line. They'll work out of the pistol. Howard will throw. Near side. Wide open. Pass caught. Nikhil Shorts, Jr.
That's just a mismatch. Shorts Jr. working against number 31, Marcus Ball, trailing in the coverage. There's not a Sun Devil even in the picture.
Mountaineers going quick again. Wendell Smallwood, not much happening there. And how about first half numbers from Skylar Howard? 13 of 24, 302 through the air.
And a lot of them in big chunks, Dave. They're not tic-tacking their way down the field. West Virginia is assaulting the Arizona State secondary right now with some big shots.
Under a minute to go before halftime. Second down and 10. Another big hitter. Down to the 6-yard line goes Jordan Thompson. He falls to the 5. That'll stop the clock to move the chains. 17 more yards.
That's an unbelievable throw. Right over Salamo Fiso at his linebacking position. Threaded the needle.
Hand off. Smallwood bounces out of trouble. Backpedals about 10 yards. He'll end up losing 5. West Virginia has a couple of timeouts left.
Well, this is one what they were looking for. Some jailbreak. He's met in the offensive backfield by 3 Sun Devils. But you got an opportunity to get out of bounds right there. Stop the clock, save a timeout. Skylar Howard came up, threw a nice block to maybe spring him to the perimeter. They were certainly looking for an inside run.
That is West Virginia, correct myself. That's their final timeout.
What they could have held on to. Didn't have a choice, though. Tackled inbounds, clock was running. That time he had an opportunity. You can hear Dana Holgorsen reminding his team, we've got no timeouts. You see, they added another 10 seconds on the game clock, 33 seconds to play with. Smallwood, who kept his feet, it was a great effort. He kept just a little bit of awareness, gets out of bounds, and could have hung on to that timeout. The red zone offense has vexed West Virginia all night long. Arizona State has done a good job of forcing field goal attempts.
Seconds to go before halftime. They will throw it to the corner. Touchdown, Mountaineers! Dekeel Shorts Jr. with a grab in the corner.
Man-to-man outside. He's working against Quishy Brown again. You see that ball just led his receiver to the back of the end zone. Quishy Brown gets turned around. Great job by Dekeel Shorts Jr. of fighting his way to get open. Great ball from Skylar Howard as well. And finally, Mountaineers get a red zone touchdown.
We've seen some quarterbacks. That is blocked. That can be scooped up back the other way. Tim White, the track star. Put 2 on the board for Arizona State.
Well, you think Sean Slocum, the special teams coach, is going to get an attaboy for that one? They defended a field goal attempt earlier with only 10 men. This time, they're able to get, looks like Ismael Murphy Richardson wiggled his way through there. And man, if the ball had to bounce to anybody, why not to your return man and Tim White? Nobody's going to walk him down. That's a good way to squeak out 2 points.
Ismael Murphy Richardson with the block. Perfect bounce right to White. Goes 90 yards. And a gifted 2 points for Arizona State. How about that? We've seen a lot tonight. What a crazy night. What a way to end bowl season.
Yeah, no kidding, huh? These two going at it. A couple of, I mean, to tell you what, some good red zone defense. West Virginia finally gets in there, and they still can't get 7 points out of the deal.
That ball is scooped up at the 48-yard line with 27 seconds left. And if you're Arizona State, you got two timeouts left. Who's to say you can't get some more points on the board right here? DJ Calhoun with a nice play.
I don't know. You see Dana Holgerson, he's saying, look, you couldn't have found a hole in the front line to pop that ball through? You dribble it right there to midfield. 27 seconds to play, those two timeouts. And we've seen this Arizona State offense attack. Number three, Rick Rumpf, who's in this game. Played a lot this season, but he hasn't started. Here's Rumpf right here. We've seen Bercovici go after him on a number of occasions.
Pass is called down to the 32-yard line. Cody Cole with the reception. Harper, who made the tackle, is down.
See him, he was actually working on Jeremy Tyler in the slot for 24. Harper came over late from his safety position. See him, that's another one of those shots. Head hit right at the hip level. Big shot to Cody Cole, who's a big man. 6'3", 235 pounds. Still working on it. Jeremy Tyler in there for Drayvon Askew-Henry. They'll spell him at times. But you can see the kickoff giving Arizona State excellent field position right at midfield. You get one completion and you're knocking on the door. At the very least, after the 2 points off a blocked extra point, and now potentially, at the very least, in field goal position. West Virginia finally able to solve the red zone riddle and get into the end zone. They still only get 6 points. The Arizona State special teams coming up big on back-to-back plays.
Well, we saw this earlier today, a tough situation in down in Memphis. Arkansas player got hurt, took a long time, got him situated. Fortunately, he's okay.
But yes.
Boy, you hate to see those type of plays. Guys leading with their head. It's just part of the game. It's just guys flying around. It's just a tough, you played the game for a long time. I don't know if you'll ever get it out of the game. It's just the way it's played. But boy, it's hard to see that.
It is hard to see. It's great to see that he's now sitting up. But this is it's nothing if not a violent game. And at the same time, you never want to see these type of ramifications. Guys coming in, they're trying to make a play. They're being aggressive. We've seen it once already on a punt return. It was an excellent tackle, both instances. But you can see part of the reason why I think the targeting rules have been so important. It's not just to protect the defenseless player on offense or whoever has the ball in his hands. It's the defender as well. You know, they don't want them to come in low. They don't want to see you coming in tackling with your head down, and you can see why it can be dangerous. It's to kind of protect both the defender and the offensive player. It's great to see West Virginia now has had two players that have been down on the turf able to leave under their own power and make it over to the sideline, but always a sobering sight to see a guy go down.
What we have seen tonight is a ton of offense. About 635 yards of offense here in the first half, and we still have 21 seconds left. Arizona State trailing by 7. Bercovici getting it cranked up through the air. 190 yards passing. First down and 10. Goes underneath. It's Balazs. He gets out of bounds right at the first down line. They'll pick up 10 yards. Kwiatkowski will get credit for the tackle. Clock stops 12 seconds. Berkovich has settled in nicely after a very sluggish start. Now 14 of 24, 200 yards. Dumps it off underneath. Clock will run.
See the timeout. Arizona State tackled inbounds. You see, they're going to take those underneath patterns, and you could see West Virginia seeding those completions.
6 seconds, one more play, or do you go ahead for the field? What do you think?
I think you got time. Take a shot. It's got to be quick. Of course, obviously, you either want an incompletion or a touchdown. You don't want it caught in the field of play outside of the end zone. You get tackled inbound somewhere, you've still got a timeout to burn.
There is Gonzalez. He is 2 out of 2 tonight. On the year, he is 24 out of 31. And they will bring him out and not take any chances. This will be a 35-yard attempt. He's hit from 37 and 19. Mitchell Fraboni will snap it to Matt Hawk. Gonzalez delivers. With 1 second remaining before halftime, Arizona State puts 3 on the board.
How about the reflexes of the clock operator? That's impressive, man. 1 second left. Bam. Squeak just one last second in this half. Because that's what we need. There just hasn't been enough offense. Not enough has happened. How about the Arizona State special teams, though, setting that up? Take nothing away from the offense. Able to move the football down the field. But the blocked extra point, 2 points. They get 5 points out of this. Didn't get in the end zone, of course. It was a special team play that set it up. Short kickoff, a dribble right there to midfield. The Sun Devils able to capitalize. Dana Holgerson, you can measure his frustration based on the height of the wisps of his hair. He's getting more and more Gene Wilder-ish as the game goes on.
I don't know how to respond to that. I don't.
It's maximum frustration. Look at that. Doesn't get any higher.
And that will do it for the first half. An explosive first half. 395 yards for West Virginia, 255 yards for Arizona State. 22-18 our score. Let's go down to Casey.
Coach, you guys gave up a blocked extra point and a field goal right at the end of half. What did you see in those couple series?
Well, you know, right now we can't get out of our own way. We'll make some good things happen on offense and defense and special teams, and then we'll turn around when something good happens. We let something bad happen. Offense finally fixed their problems and started getting the ball in the end zone, and then special teams decided to take a few plays off. So we just got to play better together.
You knew that your offense was going to have to be balanced tonight versus this defense. What have you seen from them so far?
Well, we're having a hard time running the ball, especially when they put 8 people up in there. So, you know, we knew we were going to have to throw it. They're really good against the run, and they're going to pressure a bunch. Got to continue to make plays. I think Skyler's doing a good job of putting the ball in play.
Thanks, Coach.
Got it.
Thank you very much, Casey, and he has done an exceptional job. Skyler is thrown for 334 yards. Our halftime score, West Virginia up 22-18. We'll be back with the Coke Zero halftime report right after these messages. Wrap it up. I mean, we thought we'd have some fireworks, but my goodness, it has been crazy. It was an explosive first half for West Virginia. I didn't anticipate West Virginia throwing the ball as well as they did in the first 30 minutes of this one.
Well, that's where the opportunities were coming into it. When you talk about the big plays that Arizona State has given up all season long, they've done a good job versus the run. Of the 77 20-plus yard plays they've allowed, 57 have come in the air, and it started early, right out of the gate. Skylar Howard was gunning balls downfield. Karan White, Shelton Gibson with a circus catch. They ended up in Dakeel Short's hands. And then Gibson again able to get behind the Arizona State coverage. And that was kind of the story the entire first half. But Mike Bercovici was able to find a little bit of a rhythm after starting off really slowly offensively. And it was Devin Lucien on the other end of his passes able to weave his way into the end zone. And right before half, West Virginia finally getting a red zone touchdown. They get a blocked extra point, resulted in 2 points going the other way. And after that short kickoff, Dave, given a great field position, Arizona State picked up that final field goal.
That blocked field goal that was returned, or extra point was returned for 2 points. The first time in school history Arizona State has done that. Howard is 334 yards, just to give an idea how good that was for him. He set his personal best high in the season opener against Georgia Southern when he threw for 359 in that game. He had 334 in the first half here tonight. Bercovici had 205 in the first half. Both these quarterbacks started really finding their comfort zone here in this baseball venue. Looking a little bit like Randy Johnson, throwing some fastballs in here.
Minus about 7 inches.
Right. Arizona State will have the football first. About 2 yards deep. Tim White turns the corner. Lost the football. Maybe West Virginia will have it first. Oh, the Mountaineers look like they had their hands on it for a fraction of a second, but the Sun Devils will maintain possession.
Coming in there, and it looked like it was Shelton Gibson. Was able to get his hand in there, rip that ball out of Tim White's grasp. Ball was definitely on the deck. So Gibson flying in there, and yeah, he was able to rake that ball out. I don't know how the Mountaineers weren't able to come up with it, because they were all over it.
Good throw to the outside. DJ Foster with the catch. He'll pick up 3. A pretty good job containing him. They just haven't been able to contain Devin Lucien.
Foster, you know, they open up the second half the same way they opened up their offensive play calling in the first half. Swinging the ball quickly out to DJ Foster out in the flats. See if he can't make something happen with the ball in his hands after the catch. Worth noting, too, he's just shy of that 2,400 rushing and receiving mark. It would be an NCAA record.
Game clock operator, please reset the game clock to 14:11. Play clock operator to 25 seconds. Both will start on my ready for play.
See the clock, it somehow crept back up to 14:51.
Well, we're getting a look at Manny Wilkins in at quarterback, the redshirt freshman. 6'3", 190. We were talking with new offensive coordinator Chip Lindsey about the future at quarterback, and here's one of the options. Caleb Balazs, nowhere to run. We'll get a couple of yards. Bercovici will come back in. But Wilkins gets that snap. Wilkins, along with Brady White, Bryce Perkins, some of those guys that are vying for the starting job next year. See what the recruiting class has in store, but those are the three guys on campus right now. Bercovici coming near side, has to get rid of it in a hurry. DeMario Richard. Boy, he made something out of nothing. Close to the first down, that may be good enough. Christian Brown finally brings him down.
All night long, other than one or two nice runs right there late in the second quarter, hasn't been a lot of running room. One way to get your ball carriers involved, and it was some of these passes out in the flats. Another area of weakness when you're playing cover three, especially versus soft corners.
Wide open on the far side. Tim White still on his feet. To the 20, chased down at the 15-yard line. K.J. Dillon saved a touchdown, 31 yards.
You see the horizontal passing game by Arizona State. And you can see there, Rick Rump was sliding inside. K.J. Dillon was lined up just outside the tackle box. Couldn't get wide enough, wide open there in the flat.
Big collision to Mario Richard at the 10-yard line. Pops up. Rick Rumpf ran right into Richard. It'll be second down at about 3.5.
So Arizona State pouncing on West Virginia. Off the big pass play downfield. Get the ball to DeMario Richard. Let him pound once they get in the red zone.
They'll go with Richard again. A little stutter step inside the five. First and goal, Sun Devils. Boy, where was Richard in the first half running like this?
Well, he was out there trying. He only got a couple, though, that's for sure. But a great opening series for DeMario Richard.
Beachy, a little option game near side, keeps it, falls down close to the 3-yard line.
Remember last time, though, Arizona State got down this clock tight to the goal line. West Virginia found a way to get a stop. Both there next did a great job of denying the goal line. An excellent red zone defense, as we've mentioned. Hard to come away with touchdowns versus this red zone D of the Mountaineers.
Number Arizona State not proud of. Field goals in the red zone. Here's Berkovici trying to make something out of nothing, and he does. Touchdown, Tim White. His seventh of the year.
Great job by Mike Berkovici keeping this play alive, stringing out the pass route. Makes it such a stressful situation for the D-backs.
Well, Arizona State led the FBS in red zone field goals made with 20 coming into this game. That is not a number you want to hang your hat on. They could have used a lot more of this year. Berkovici making something happen, scrambling, finding his guy Tim White in the back of the end zone. They now lead it by 3. Arizona State back out in front, 25-22. Motel 6 Cactus Bowl. Back and forth we go. Berkovici doing his job. Big place, a big part of this game.
A simple play this time, because watch, you're going to see K.J. Dillon get pulled inside. DeMario Richard is going to be out here all alone. You just wait. Middle field safety is trying to crash down, come downfield. Not a big gainer on this one. Richard does a lot with it, but watch on the next play. Number 81, you see K.J. Dillon sink inside. And that time, Gary Chambers floating up, and it gets a soft corner, and Rick Rumpf is just easy pickings for the receiver on the perimeter.
Touchback at the 25. Let's go downstairs, get an update with Casey.
Well, Dave, just like you guys were just talking about, Arizona State head coach Todd Graham told me that the storyline of the first half was those explosive plays. He was very unhappy defensively with the big shots that they gave up downfield. He did say that they were happy on how they shut down the running game against a West Virginia offense that has been really good on the ground this season. But he said offensively they wanted to carry that momentum. And guys, let me tell you, down here on this sideline, there is a lot of energy, a lot of excitement, especially surrounding Mike Berkovici.
You know, it's been their story all year, these big plays. We told you the number early on. I think it's worth repeating. They've allowed 21 plays over 40 yards this year, as is Arizona State defense. No team in the country has done that over the last 5 years. It's been feast or famine for the Sun Devils defensively. Smallwood churning it out over the 30 to the 32. Stop there, gain of 7.
Nice run, though, to open up this series. It's power run that time. This is the run element that Dana Holgorsen has incorporated into his ground game more and more ever since he brought Ron Crook, offensive line coach, from Stanford.
He'll dump it off to Smallwood. Makes a nice catch around the shins. Looks like he'll lose a couple of yards on that play. Loses his helmet as well. Smallwood will have to come off for a play. Not bad when you can come in with Russell Shell.
That's right. You look at West Virginia a year ago, Russell Shell seemed to be set for an even bigger year than his 2014 campaign, especially with the emphasis on the ground game. But it was Smallwood's ability to run between the tackles to help elevate him on the depth chart to get him the bulk of the carries.
They'll hand it off to Shell. Kicks it to the outside. First down around the 37-yard line. A transfer from Pitt back in 2014. Put up some staggering numbers coming out of high school. Pennsylvania's all-time leading rusher. Over 9,000 yards in high school.
Unbelievable. And you can see that was a great bounce run on a third and long. You dial up a running play and you're able to convert.
Couple of pump fakes.
Howard's pass incomplete.
It'll be second down and 10. Howard took a couple of really big shots in that first half. Didn't fluster him. Took a lot of shots this year. One of the reasons Dana Holgorsen said he's had an up-and-down season throwing the football. Lost some confidence.
Exactly. Yeah, he mentioned that. You know, of course, they had a young receiving core. Last year, they had Mario Alford, Kevin White, Ron White's big brother. They had to get their timing down. It's hard to do that when the quarterback isn't upright.
That's plenty of time going deep down the middle. Gary Jennings is there to the 10, to the 5, touchdown! 64 yards.
Can't say enough on some of these shots, the time that Skyler Howard has to deliver the ball downfield. That ball hung up into the air for, I don't know, 5 seconds it seemed like. Probably was more like 3. Punters would be thrilled with this kind of hang time. And look at the pocket. It's wide open. Just gives Gary Jennings enough time to run underneath this football. He'd already beaten the coverage of Quishy Brown. Big plays. The ones that have frustrated Todd Graham going into halftime rear their ugly head early in the second half.
Gary Jennings, one of those freshmen that they have been trying to get untracked. He had 4 receptions early in the year against Liberty, but only 1 reception the rest of the year. That covers 10 games. But he had a big one here that goes 64 yards for the touchdown. His first reception of this game. Oh, go Coach Holgorsen. 28-25.
The 2016 Motel 6 Cactus Bowl. Brought to you by Ally Bank. Your money needs an ally. Heineken. Open your world, enjoy responsibly. And Little Caesars, try our new large deep, deep dish pizza for just $8.
That's how Matt and I got to the game today. Just kidding. That's the Arizona Skyhawks, the official parachute team of the Motel 6 Cactus Bowl. All the members of the team are professionally rated by the United States Parachute Association, brought our game ball in with them. And right after, good thing they got there on time, because right after they came, they closed the roof here at Chase Field.
It's a good thing they got in here. They had some important elements like the coin and the ball. Could have played without it.
Arizona State up 29-25, 9:48 to play. Oh. Kalen Ballage on the return. Let's go back to that touchdown that went 64 yards.
You see him line up in a stack right here. Jordan Thompson, he's going to come up and then threaten the safety, and it's going to pull the safety inside. And you'll see Jennings, he's just going to run basically right up the hash. Stacked right here. Pulls Marcus Ball into safety all the way across the formation. And you see Jennings, that ball ended up pulling him all the way to the opposite hash. You see how much time that route took to develop. That time Arizona State did not pressure, only brought four pass rushers. West Virginia left some extra blockers in to make sure that Skylar Howard had enough time to deliver that football downfield.
Career high 395 through the air for Howard. Three touchdown passes. Let's see what Berkovici has in store. He's thrown for 255. That'll be a delay game.
Delay game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
I have a hard time putting my arms around that when you come out of a...
Yeah. It's like coming out of a timeout. You open a possession. You really, I mean, there's no motion. You're looking at it going, I don't know what it is that you're waiting on to see. You can see that, you know, partly you wonder if it's clarity of what you're trying to accomplish for offensive coordinators.
Ballage, nowhere to go. Will still manage to pick up a couple of yards on the ground. Arizona State's offense this year put together 184 yards a game on the ground. That was fifth in the Pac-12, 51st in the country. But they're facing this West Virginia defense that has held the last three opponents to under 100 yards rushing. Pass caught by Ballage right at the line of scrimmage. It'll be third down and 10.
It's a great open field tackle by Nick Witkowski. See what they love in him. That's what makes him such a prolific tackler. A strong side linebacking position. He had to run all the way over there and Ballage in the open field to get him tackled for the next to no gain.
West Virginia dropping back, only rushing three. That was off the hands of Devin Lucien.
Lucien. He's made his big plays, been working against Rick Rump that time versus Terrell Chestnut. The coaches mentioned what kind of season he had this year. Really came on playing his best football. See coaches over there speaking with Mike Berkovici. We talked about him earlier, how involved he was in this game plan, knowing the offensive coaching staff had to be reshuffled a little bit. Roles had to be expanded from a play calling standpoint.
Off to punt is a good one. Gary Jennings backpedals to the 17. Jennings trying to turn the corner. Jennings will be out of bounds at the 38-yard line. A 54-yard punt and a 20-yard return. Story of the day so far has to be the quarterback, Skylar Howard. The juniors had an up and down season, but today it has been all up.
Yeah, from a passing standpoint, yeah. From the trajectory of the ball.
Right.
You can see it this whole game. They came out gunning for this Arizona State defense, and they were attacking right from the get-go. We've seen big play after big play in the passing game where they've been able to exploit good protection by the offensive unit and some poor coverage on the back end from Arizona State.
Throw it again. Why not? Flushed out of the pocket, and we'll get it out of bounds. No flags. But Howard chasing down some records right now. He's already set a career high. Drew Bledsoe threw for 476 back in 1992 in the Cactus Bowl.
Let's see, that's about four more completions.
Yeah,
the way this game's going.
Stacked receivers each side. Howard will keep it himself. Let's go down to Casey.
Well, Dave, Todd Graham down here on the Arizona State sideline echoing what he told me at halftime, that this storyline is simply about the big plays that this defense is giving up. He said, guys, when I call the coverage, we have to execute it. We need to stop giving them these opportunities. Do not let the ball get thrown over you. Get set, get in your stance. Do not continue to give them these opportunities.
Here comes some pressure. Howard in trouble. Dumps it off underneath. Wellman, nowhere to go. Pressure worked well that time for Arizona State. Loss of three, forcing a fourth down.
Interesting that you would say that, Casey, about getting in your stance, getting ready to go. That time, ball was snapped. Arizona State wasn't even in their stances, and yet Tayshaun Smallwood still able to get pressure on Skylar Howard. We've seen them more prepared on previous snaps with less success. That time, Arizona State able to get in the backfield.
Over end kick. Nice grab by White on the run. He'll get it out close to the 35-yard line. Folks, the stage has been set for the College Football Playoff National Championship game presented by AT&T. A chance to see some outstanding players like Heisman Trophy winner Derrick Henry, as he'll carry the Crimson Tide into the championship game against Deshaun Watson and the undefeated Clemson Tigers. Tune in Monday, January 11th, 8:30 on ESPN, also streaming live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app. I tell you, at the end of the day, people can make arguments who didn't get in, who's left out, who shouldn't have been there. I think the two best teams are playing for it. Whatever you can say, these are the two best teams.
Yes, sir. And for those folks clamoring for an expanded playoff, did we really want to see more teams? Did we watch the New York Liberty State games? More blowouts. I think this is, if you had to crystallize the best two teams out of this entire college football season, we're going to get to see them play right down the street next Monday.
I cannot wait. I cannot wait. That is going to be a showcase of a ton of NFL talent.
You should just stay. Cancel your flight and just hang out in Phoenix for a little while.
Think they'll let me?
Who's they? The wife.
Second down. Bercovici. Ooh, big collision, 48. But Lucien holds on. My goodness. The collision. Drayvon Askew, Henry. But Lucien pops up like nothing happened.
We've seen Askew Henry drive on the ball before and make big shots. But Lucien, once again, on Arizona State's first touchdown drive, made a great catch over the middle.
Balazs hit, stood up. You know what I liked about that play? Drayvon Askew Henry had a chance. Old school, might have led with the helmet. He came in with a shoulder. He knew he was in the open field. And it was one of those hits that could have gone the wrong way.
Yeah. Great shot. Still a phenomenal collision. But he played it smart. Keeps him safe as much as it does the receiver.
Second down. And seven. Boy, Lucien, I just have been thoroughly impressed with this young man. Play clock down to five. Bercovici coming near side. Wouldn't you know it, 15 again. And he was looked like the third option. I'd make him my first option every time. Boy, he's going tonight. How many catches is that for him? That's 9 for 144 tonight.
Yeah, warrants a little attention, doesn't he? You could see as Bercovici came up to the line checking, as West Virginia checked in kind, looked over to the sideline, Tony Gibson making their adjustments to drop and only bring three.
DJ Foster on the far side, incomplete. KJ Dillon shadowing him. Foster having a tough time getting it going tonight.
Yeah, he's been kind of quiet. Well, they gave him a carry earlier on. We mentioned just shy of that record. It's been Devin Lucien's night by and large. You know, coming into this game, Foster only had 106 touches. It was the fewest amount he's had in his 4 years at Arizona State. This is his first year he had more receiving yards than rushes.
Bercovici will throw it. White breaks a tackle, and then some. White to the five, touchdown. What a run.
Arizona State is so aggressive in this run pass option. Look how Bercovici attacks the line of scrimmage and then dumps late. You see KJ Dillon. He's another all Big 12 performer. Frustrated, he missed that tackle, and let's see if he steps out before he gets into the end zone. Hard to see from that angle.
It was close. Tim White, 33 yards.
The ruling on the field is a touchdown. It's under further review.
Earlier in the first half, we saw a reception right along the boundary. The ruling was that it was a catch, and it was kind of a similar look. I wonder if it's his right foot that reaches over his heel. Does his heel touch on the white? Very similar to that catch, really. Is his heel touching the white right here? Establishing him out of bounds before he gets to the end zone. Javon Askew Henry is right there.
Is that indisputable video evidence?
Exactly.
Is the only question yeah. I would have.
It's got to be clear. Hard to say if that's clear. I think it's very similar to the catch we saw in the first. And that ultimately was ruled a catch. Looks like he was in bounds. Not enough to me anyway to see there that would establish him out. This is the best look at it.
I just think it's hard to tell if that yeah. heel hit the white line.
After review, the ruling on the field stands as called. Touchdown, Arizona State.
I agree with that. You know, it was just wasn't enough to overturn it. Great play by White. Unbelievable. Tremendous effort. Three broken tackles to get into that end zone.
This is our fifth lead change. Gonzalez with that point after has now set the school record. Remember Luis Sendejas? He was a machine. Well, he just moved to second place. Zane Gonzalez, the new points record holder at Arizona State. Why? He gives some credit to Tim White. Breaks off a 33-yard reception. 32-29, Sun Devils. Good look inside Chase Field. Roof is closed tonight. Home of the Arizona Diamondbacks. But tonight, it's the Motel 6 Cactus Bowl. Five lead changes. And the lead right now favors Arizona State. It has been back and forth we go. It didn't start off too well for Arizona State. The first quarter was not very kind offensively for the Sun Devils, but I think they found a little something in this little run pass option game.
It's something that they can do, that's for sure. Puts the perimeter defenders in a big bind and muddies the read for linebackers and safeties. They don't know what you're trying to accomplish.
And this was exactly that type of play.
See, Bercovici, he's just going to sprint out hard to his left and watch him attack the line of scrimmage off the play fake. They even have a lead blocker, and he just spits the ball out there to White. And he does a great job. He breaks K.J. Dillon's tackle. It's a well-defended play. Really should have been tackled for no gain, little to no gain. And he just fights his way through those, shows some of that speed, gets in the end zone.
Boy, he had a little two-man game, receiver game. If one of those receivers kind of drifts off deep, he can lob it over the top of that, too. Let's see what West Virginia has. He'll go with Wendell Smallwood. He'll throw it out of the backfield. Marcus Ball with his third tackle. Smallwood will pick up 4 yards.
Look at that Arizona State offense. You mentioned they might have found something. They've got the three possessions. Opening possession to go right down the football field, get a touchdown. And then in this one, second effort gets him another. And that punt in between. Forcing West Virginia to try to hold serve.
Howard going to the wide side of the field. Pass is caught. Nikhil Shorts with another reception. Shorts with his fourth catch. Picks up 17 on that one.
Mentioned ever since Skylar Howard, he took that big shot in the second quarter. He was able to come back from that. We saw a couple of overthrows early in the game. Saw one deep shot where he just barely missed a deep one to David Sills. He's also been dialed in, threaded that one.
Going up top again, looking for Gibson. Makes the over-shoulder catch, and it is complete. They'll talk about it, and will they spot it? Yes, they will spot it at the 12-yard line.
No, I think that left foot was out.
By the length of the big toe.
That's right. Look at it, see his left leg was out.
The ruling on the field is a completed catch is under further review.
I don't know if that ball was ever going to come back down. And Skylar Howard, you know, we're in this. This is a baseball venue. I couldn't see the ball there for a second. Out. You see him there possessing the football. See his foot right there. We've seen two other plays similar to this one. We're talking about the boundary. Did he get his foot in? The previous ones was this heel down inbounds. Well, this one looks to me like his toe all the way to his midfoot. Touchdown out of bounds. Never established himself as inbounds while possessing the football. But he was open. Make no mistake. That ball just drifted too far outside, and it hung in the air again. Forever, just like the pass to Gary Jennings.
So with the incomplete pass, now it looks like our communication system has gone down with our replay booth, and the chains have already moved. So this is going to take a minute because they got to move the chains all the way back to where the original line of scrimmage was, get the clock set. Jeff Cervinski, our referee, our crew out of the Big Ten, going the conventional landline now. Love it. It's old school. How many? You don't see many of those anymore, do you?
You really don't. I wonder if he can read Morse code if necessary. Actually, that was pretty quick considering the landline.
After further review, the ruling on the field of the catch is confirmed. First down and 10.
Wow. Whoa.
Maybe there's something wrong with the communication line. Tim, we have Tim O'Day up here with us, the referee. Tim, is there something I'm missing?
Well, let's take a look here at the receiver's right foot. The question is, does he make the catch while his right foot is actually still on the ground? I think we can agree that it looks like the left foot comes down out of bounds, but did the right foot actually, was it actually his toes on the ground when the ball was possessed? That's the question.
I can tell you the 40-some-odd thousand Sun Devil fans in here don't agree.
Ooh, that's a quick, if so, that was, he established possession pretty quickly. It's a good point, though. You can see it right there where his right foot may have been drugged.
To the end zone. Shorts makes the catch. Give him the six. 17 yards. What a grab. Dakeel Shorts with his second touchdown reception of the game.
Once again, Dakeel Shorts is fighting through the coverage of Solomon Means. He's playing for an injured Jordan Simone at the safety position. He's missed the last two games for the Sun Devils. Neil Shorts able to come up with a big catch in the end zone.
Over, unsportsmanlike conduct, offense number six. The 15-yard penalty will be assessed on the kickoff.
With the types of returns that Arizona State has gotten, that could be dangerous. Certainly get a chance to do that. But these two offenses just throwing haymakers at each other.
A lot of home run balls.
Yeah.
Inside the Diamondbacks home stadium. Wow. Lambert to attempt the point after. Howard has now put up 467 yards through the air. 22 of 35, four touchdown passes. Let's go back to the prior play that set this all up. Look at the right foot of Shelton Gibson. Does he make contact with possession of the football with his right foot? Keep an eye on the right foot. There's possession. Where is the right foot? Is there contact to the turf?
And does he have control of the football there? Wow. He's definitely touching the ball with his right foot. It looks to me like that right toe is still in contact with the grass.
So let me bring in Tim O'Day one more time. In that situation, Tim, he does have contact with the football, okay? I wouldn't say it's full possession, but there is contact. And let's say a cleat is with the turf. Does that constitute?
The process of the catch is a big issue right now. Everybody's talking about it from the NFL on down through college.
Right.
So it looks to me like the receiver has possession of the ball. It's pinned to his shoulder pad. And the guys in the replay are looking at this thing in frame by frame.
Right.
And they're evidently picking out that toe is down. You can see it right there. Possession, ball trapped against the shoulder pad. So they're ruling that the process of the catch was complete. Right foot on the ground, complete ball.
Huge play in this game. Huge play in this game. Sun Devil fans don't like it. And they dominate this crowd. Only 20 minutes or so from Tempe. Here's Tim White trying to change the course of events. The track star has some room on the far side. He has been a huge factor tonight. The football season ends today. The indoor track season begins on the 4th.
That's right. Well, it looks like he's getting ready early, getting nice and warmed up. How big is the unsportsmanlike conduct now? You get a guaranteed shot at a nice return, and Tim White has been lethal. Between him and Devin Lucien, they have been a difference in this game for Arizona State. If it wasn't the run after catch on the previous touchdown, and now setting up the Sun Devil offense just outside the red zone to open up this series of downs.
First down and 10. Berkovici with that little run pass option again, trying to hit Jalen Harvey. 36-32, 2:46 to go in the third quarter.
It's bowl mania, right? And it's maniacal offense so far in this game, just back and forth. Shots being taken, special teams plays, especially by Arizona State. You see the Sun Devils knocking on the door once again.
Berkovici to the 25-yard line. Give him 3 yards. Now you're looking at third down and 7.
I see Berkovici pull the ball very much in the zone read game. This time it was a great pull. Excellent play by Jeremy Tyler to collapse back downfield. Get Berkovici down to the turf to force a third and long. And you see Terrell Chestnut, he's cramping up in the end zone. We've seen a lot of plays. There's been a little bit of a layoff, bowl prep. It's pretty arid out here in the desert. Make sure that you're hydrated properly. Maybe both of his calves locked up. West Virginia already playing down a corner coming into this game with Darryl Worley unavailable. Terrell Chestnut will at least miss one snap.
This has been an absolutely crazy game. You know, coming into this, we kind of anticipated we'd see quite a bit of offense in this, but we're closing in on 1,000 yards.
It's how those 1,000 yards have been amassed. Methodical drives? No, sir. We're talking 15, 20-yard chunks at minimum. And it's been that way really since the second quarter. Arizona State got in on the action offensively. Watch the play call on this third and long. We're seeing Arizona State and Mike Bercovici willing to go after Rick Rumpf. Now that Terrell Chestnut's out, typically what you'll see is offenses go after their backup. Whoever comes in substitution. It's going to be Rasul Douglas right here. 13. He lined up across from Tim White.
Let's see if Bercovici goes right at him. Here comes some pressure. And a flag down, false start.
Offense, number five. 5-yard penalty, third down.
That was against 15, not five. Lucy in right in front of the official on that sideline.
Sometimes you'll see offenses, they'll hold the count a little bit to get a defense to tip their hand, but those defenses, when they stem in their blitz look, can be hard to hold your water, even at receiver.
So now it's third down and a dozen. Three-man rush, Bercovici. Pass is caught down to the 23-yard line. Gain of 8. And here comes the field goal unit. So Arizona State's all-time leading score trots back out for field goal attempt number 4. Remember in his last game against Cal, he hit 6 out of 6. Trying to make it 4 out of 4 tonight. This is a 40-yarder. He's hit from 37, 19, and 35 from the middle of the field. And he misses. Off to the right, and West Virginia stands up.
See the defense, big third down stand, aided by the false start. Pushes Gonzalez in this attempt back just a little bit more. Luis Sendejas somewhere breathing a sigh of relief. He's already been eclipsed from a scoring record standpoint. He don't want to get, want to show off, Zane. And as it is, you're on the West Virginia sideline. You're pleased that Arizona State didn't inch ever closer.
.108 in the third quarter. The Mountaineer offense back on the field. Howard, 22 of 35. Make him 23 out of 36 with that completion. William Kress Jr. getting some action. The backup quarterback coming in, making a reception. A redshirt freshman out of Baltimore.
Both backup quarterbacks making cameos in this game. Manny Wilkins got in for a snap. Why not let William Kress Jr. in there for a quick reception? Nice run after the catch as well.
Second short. Howard going over the middle. This one is picked off. Kareem Moore with his 6th interception of the year. Dropped at the 35-yard line. The freshman All-American returns it 24 yards.
Skylar Howard got greedy on this one. As you're going to see Kareem Moore, and he's just going to drift back and play center field. Skylar Howard high with that pass. As we mentioned, he's threaded quite a few, but we've seen some overthrows. Protection was fantastic. They maxed it out. Plenty of time. And that ball was high and behind Caron White and right to Kareem Moore, the freshman All-American safety for Arizona State. And once again, excellent field position on consecutive possessions.
And White, the 32-yard line, 3.5, maybe 4. 6th interception of the year for the freshman, the true freshman, who had never played safety before until the 3rd game of the year, but due to some injuries and whatnot on the back end, they forced him in there, and now they say he's kind of found a home. That's his future home here at Arizona State. See how big that interception will be as this one unfolds. Three quarters are in the books. It is a shootout here in Phoenix. The Motel 6 Cactus Bowl, 15 more minutes to go. Game summary. I mean, this, we could write a whole book on this game, but we'll just give you one page on our graphic summary here. I mean, it's just been crazy. Six lead changes, closing in on 1,000 yards. How about 11 plays, 20-plus yards? And how about Skylar Howard? 476 yards passing, four touchdowns. Second down coming up for Arizona State from the 31. Foster will pick up a yard. Rutkowski with his fifth tackle for West Virginia.
Rutkowski is so physical that he knocked his own defensive tackle down, Christian Brown, one of their biggest players. He's still shaking it off. Look at number 95. He got blown up by his own teammate. He's still trying to get right for this snap.
Third down at 5. Here comes some heat. Quick throw. Lucien didn't get his head turned around quick enough. Berkovici was feeling some pressure. Now it's 4th and 5, kind of in that no man's land. And here comes the field goal units.
At that time, Tony Gibson brought that edge pressure. 5 men unaccounted for right in Berkovici's face. He had to deliver that football early. And as you mentioned, Lucien wasn't ready to get his head around. And once again, West Virginia's third down defense able to hold up, force this field goal attempt. Gonzalez missing his previous.
Long this year is 45. This is from 48. Plenty of leg. Hammers it through the uprights. Didn't have much time to think about that 40-yard miss just a few seconds ago. He will pull Arizona State to within one. He is now 4 out of 5 tonight. A no-doubter.
Some points off of turnovers, and we talked about this coming into the game. First time under Todd Graham where they didn't have a positive turnover margin. His first year they were +6, 13 and 14. They were +15, +14. This year neutral, 19 takeaways, 19 turnovers. Those are big momentum swings, but it's also possessions that you're not getting for your offense. And they depressed some of their scoring. Score as much, gave up more points, hurt their defense, hurt their offensive output. See, this game, the turnovers are able to provide Arizona State with some scoring opportunities. They've got 6 off the turnovers for this game.
Gonzalez set to kick off for Arizona State.
So Gonzalez with 4 field goals tonight. Now hit 16 of his last 17. In a timeout taken on the kickoff.
Timeout.
Arizona State.
Arizona State, their first of the half, 30 seconds in length.
Oh, boy.
Well, they had all 11 guys out on the field. I don't know if they were thinking, were they going to try to steal a possession? It's against Sean Slocum.
It's not been a good night.
You know, he needs to remind Coach Graham. Remember, we blocked the extra point.
Look at Coach Graham in the background. Oh, boy.
Blowtorch at Sean Slocum. I don't know. I wonder if they were going to try to steal a possession right there, Dave.
And somebody didn't get lined up right, perhaps. Are you kidding me? Yeah, it's almost like they had something they wanted to do right there, and somebody wasn't on the same page.
11 guys out there. Either the alignment wasn't right, they were going for a directional kick, and they just to have the distribution they wanted.
Oh.
Well, it's the final weekend of the NFL regular season tomorrow, so kick off your morning with us right here on ESPN. First at 10 a.m. Eastern, NFL Insider Sunday edition with injury news and early breaking stories. Then at 11, Sunday NFL Countdown with Wendy Nix, Boomer, and the rest of the boys. Takes you right up till kickoff. Also streaming live on the ESPN app. We are the final bowl game of this football season. Of course, there is one more to go, and that would be the national championship game a week from Monday, just down the road. University of Phoenix Stadium in Glendale, Arizona. Here's Wendell Smallwood turning the corner. Smallwood to the 40-yard line. Big 15-yard pickup to get it started on this drive.
Nice run by Wendell Smallwood, able to get outside. They popped a couple of runs. They've had more success than Arizona State has on the ground, but they're not near the production that West Virginia has enjoyed all season long on the ground. One of the top rushing attacks in the country. Smallwood relatively quiet in comparison to the balance of the season.
Smallwood slips on the turf. By the way, speaking of this turf, they brought in this turf special for this bowl game and laid it right over the baseball turf. Pretty unique.
Amazing that it could be able to take root or it wouldn't be slipping underneath it.
It's in great shape down there. Loss of two. Skylar Howard hits the deck. There's a good look at it right there. Laid it right on top of the baseball turf, and it it is flawless down there.
I hadn't seen really any issues with the footing. Even with the folks parachuting in with the coin and the football, they were able to come in and skid down the turf with area mark left. Big third down and 10 plus. We saw this in the opening possession for West Virginia. They were able to overcome it with a big completion to Caron White downfield.
Howard steps up in the pocket. That one was almost picked off. Intended for Shelton Gibson. Brown stepped in front of it, knocks it away, and forces a punting situation for the Mountaineers.
You know, if Kwesi Brown doesn't try to make a play on this ball, Shelton Gibson probably isn't going to get the first down anyway, unless he's able to break a tackle. Made that reception about 4 yards shy of the distance needed to go. Now off an interception, Arizona State, they get the sack, get a big third down stop.
One-point game. Gorgeous night. Downtown Phoenix, Motel 6 Cactus Bowl. Coming back in a moment. There it is, the last trophy of the bowl season to be handed out tonight at some point, or this morning, depending on which coast you live on. The Motel 6 Cactus Bowl, 2016 champion. Boy, we had some of the games in the New Year's Six. How about the job Clemson did? Deshaun Watson just put on a show. Clemson Tigers, Dabo Sweeney headed to the national championship game against Alabama, who just put on a clinic. Cyrus Jones, you want to talk about an electrifying player. He is one. And Ohio State, Ezekiel Elliott.
I'll tell you what, and then of course, you know, the Rose Bowl, what Christian McCaffrey did, announced his presence. That's his candidacy is official for the Heisman Trophy next year. But you mentioned earlier, Dave, Clemson and Alabama. You maybe could make a case for Ohio State. What a missed opportunity they had. One of the better teams in the country. Didn't see the early at the ball.
Here goes Manny Wilkins in at quarterback. Redshirt freshman. Picks up 13 yards on the scamper to the near sideline.
Stick him in there. We mentioned Mike Bercovici. I think he's only pulled it once on the zone read looks, but Wilkins, a little bit more of a threat. A freshman, heir apparent at the quarterback spot.
DJ Foster comes in at running back, trying to pick up some of that 49 yards he needs to become the only player in college football history with 2,400 yards receiving, 2,400 yards rushing.
I think it's a package. We've seen Manny Wilkins in there. Foster's been getting carries as well. Something that they may be trying to get going as a change of pace in the offensive backfield.
Foster has rushed four times for only 2 yards tonight. Looks like Kyle Rose, the injured Mountaineer. Hey, after we wrap up here at Chase Field, stick around for SportsCenter at Night with the coach and Max. They'll have highlights from Nuggets Warriors, the bowl games, the NHL, college hoops, and the rest of the NBA. SportsCenter at Night after our game on ESPN and streaming live on the ESPN app. And you will want to watch some of those highlights from the game that preceded us. That was one of the craziest games you will ever see. Biggest bowl comeback in history.
Kyle Rose, we've mentioned him a couple of times, having to patrol the middle of the Mountaineer defensive front. Going to lead the game a little bit. I don't know if they were working on cramps on him or not. Interestingly, Terrell Chestnut still hasn't returned. Rasul Douglas still lined up.
Jordan Beachy. It's Foster. Foster with a first down at the 43. Budkowski chases him down, but a gain of a dozen. Now Arizona State going quick.
Get those gateway plays, a big play, jump the ball. Keep the defense on its heels, don't allow them to substitute.
Berkovici going up top. Boy, there was a collision back at the 45-yard line. Foster and K.J. Dillon collided, no flags.
I'll tell you what, you know, most of tonight, the officials have let them play. Well, there's been quite a bit of contact. We've even seen a flag come out, only to be waved off. See a lot of hand fighting there. I don't know that there was enough. K.J. Dillon, stride for stride. Both guys looking to gain an advantage.
Nice play from Jared Barber coming in from that middle backer spot. No gain on the play.
See Jared Barber substituting out. Third and long. They get their nickel package in there. Edward Muldrow, number 20, comes in on those rundowns. Jared Barber is the guy you want in the defense. Seven tackles so far here tonight. We talked about how active the Mountaineer linebackers are. And a difficult third down. Arizona State facing offensively.
Three-man rush. Rukovici steps up, fires a bullet over the middle. Pass is caught. Cody Cole with the reception. 15 yards, move the chains.
Cody Cole coming into this game at 30 catches. We've seen him pop up a couple of times. It's a well-thrown football. Right in front of Drayvon Askew Henry. Looks like Askew Henry is down now. We've seen a number of their secondary players go down in this game. Chestnut's already out. Gerard Harper, who left the game injured at one point. Now Askew Henry, slow to get up. Number six, Cody Cole break right in front of him on the dig. Not sure where he got injured. Virginia, number six. He's holding his left knee. Shane Commodore, number 38 now, in for Askew Henry. See him right here, middle field safety.
Berkovici now at 360 yards through the air, three touchdowns, no picks. Going wide side of the field. Incomplete. He was looking for Gary Chambers. Clock will stop. 9:53 to play.
You think back to some of those red zone opportunities that West Virginia had early in this game when they were rolling before Arizona State was able to get any traction offensively. Dana Holgorsen very frustrated with their inability to get 6 points out of those trips. Right now, in a 1-point game.
No gain. Balazs hit by Wachuku, the junior out of Wiley, Texas.
See Arizona State. They're staying true to that ground game. They're coming back to it at times. It just hasn't happened for them other than about two or three carries on one drive. It's been all in the air, playmaking after the catch at the receiver position.
Here comes some heat. Berkovici hammered as he let it go. Almost picked off in the middle of the field. Petaway put the pressure on Berkovici.
That time Tony Gibson brought Petaway from the boundary and K.J. Dillon from the field. Neither were picked up. Petaway gets there first. Coach has mentioned he's an excellent blitzer, showing that athleticism there. Berkovici narrowly able to get that pass off. At the end of all these series, when he's over there, it seems as if the coaches have questions about the decisions that were made on the field.
That will hit at the 12 and go out of bounds inside the 10. Nice punt from Matt Hawk, 34 yards. Well, Skylar Howard is tied with Drew Bledsoe for the Cactus Bowl record passing yards. Will he break it? Something tells me he will. We'll find out when we come back.
The 2016 Motel 6 Cactus Bowl, brought to you by Motel 6. We'll leave the light on for you. And Quicksilver from Capital One. Earn unlimited 1.5% cash back every purchase, every day.
Hey, I'm glad this is the Motel 6 Bowl, because the way this is going, I'm glad somebody's going to leave a light on for us. It's going to be a late night no matter which side of the coast you're on. How about this? I mean, this is crazy numbers. Crazy numbers. Still have 9:06 to go.
Here's the craziest part. Look at these third downs. I mean, these teams are piling up yards. And they're doing it all on first and second down. You get them to third, they're getting off the field.
Flag comes in right in the area of holding. That may be also a chop block. There look like two West Virginia players. There's going to be a hold. I saw two white jerseys get up right around one Arizona State defender. But
holding. Offense, number 63. Penalties decline. Second down.
See, defense doing a great job already. Special teams done a great job of pinning West Virginia back. Right here. And Kyle Bosch, you see there, yeah, when you end up dumping the guy, you tip him a little bit.
Howard coming near side. That one is almost picked off. Brown almost had a pick six.
You see Skylar Howard, there's a lot of trust here because the ball's out of his hands and Jennings hadn't even made his break yet. You know, the timing a little bit off on that one. You see Howard expecting Jennings to have been a little bit wider at that point. Greasy Brown had a window to jump right in front of him.
Third and 12, danger zone if you're the Mountaineers here. Oh, keep it on the ground. Shell breaks a tackle, breaks another tackle to the 15. Should have enough for the first down. Needed 12, and I think he got 13 yards.
The last time that West Virginia had a third and long, it was about a third and seven, I believe. They handed the football off to Russell Shell. And he picked up the first down. That was only their second conversion of the game. They now have three. That time, third and 10 plus, and number seven able to deliver. That's a big third down. You're playing with a one-point lead. If nothing else, eats a little bit of clock, but also buys you a little bit of field position to get out of shadowing your own goal post.
You just can't miss those tackles if you're Arizona State. Going down the middle. Looking for Devontae Mathis.
K. keep in mind with all these deep shots that West Virginia's taking. No Javon Durant in this game either, true freshman. You see Skylar Howard, he takes another big shot, that time from Christian Sam, blitzing from his linebacker position. It's the sixth pressure we've seen, second pressure from Sam tonight. See Arizona State, well, they keep at it. They're going to pressure, they're going to blitz.
Out of that pistol formation, they'll go with Wendell Smallwood. Ran right into Salamo Fiso. Fiso now with 11 tackles, two behind the line of pressure, a pick, and a sack.
The ball hadn't hit downfield. It's been tackled or played in the air by Salamo Fiso. He's had a heck of a game in his linebacker spot.
Howard, quick throw. Needed to get it just over the 29. They get it to the 30. That's another first down. Gary Jennings with the reception.
Gary Jennings, a true freshman. You see how young this receiver core is. Wholesale changes as they substitute in. We're getting later in the game. Ron White comes out. Jennings comes out.
And Skylar Howard has just set the Cactus Bowl record, surpassing Drew Bledsoe. 480 yards passing. His previous high, by the way, was in the opener against Georgia Southern. 359 through the air. Going for a lot more here. Has a man just off the fingertips of David Sills. Second time tonight that he has just missed Sills.
Two-man route. Good.
In our conference calls with coaches today, Holgerson said that the young receivers, they just haven't been on the same page. But I got to tell you, they've looked like they have been pretty in tune tonight.
By and large, you know, you look at Gary Jennings and now a true freshman, and David Sills, and you're right, that's the second time and Dana Holgerson has collapsed in exhaustion. Just can't believe it. Two shots to Sills that they missed.
Just by fractions. Oh, Howard is hammered. He is still on the ground. Christian Sam again.
I'll tell you what, one of the things Dana Holgerson said he loved about Skylar Howard was his toughness. He floats outside of the pocket, just a little bit to his left, still almost got the ball to Gary Jennings. Nice arm streak, but tremendous toughness standing in there to deliver.
Third down and 10. 480-yard passing for Howard. Over the middle. That one is incomplete. Looking for White. A little bit behind him and a little bit high. And here comes the punt team. They did take off. That first down they got when they were backed up took an extra 2.5 minutes off the clock.
Well, a little bit. Of course, we've seen the big plays in this game. It doesn't take long. And especially with what we've seen from Tim White in the return game, you hope that you get off a big punt if you're West Virginia. Nice coverage downfield.
O'Toole's punt yielded by White. Dropping to 27, a 45-yard punt. 6:19 to go. The senior, Mike Berkovici, trying to finish with a flurry. His club down a point. Time is running out. And now let's take a look at the Bowl Challenge Cup brought to you by Progressive. As you see the Southeastern Conference, what a bowl season for the SEC, setting a record for any conference in bowl season with 8 victories. Pac-12 had a chance, but faltered just before we came on the air today.
You just knew that Oregon, the way they were playing, up big over TCU. Well, the Big 12 needed that victory to get their second win. And scrapping for one, hanging on to a 1-point lead.
They're going to call what appears to be a flag on a late hit on Manny Wilkins. And Dana Holgerson cannot believe it. He came 15 yards down the field. Now, if they're going to pick up that, what we thought was a pass interference call.
After the play was over, personal foul, defense, number 42, 15-yard penalty
automatic first down.
As Manny Wilkins kept running, even.
Once again, Arizona State opening up the series with Manny Wilkins.
Was he down?
He didn't look down. He's certainly not a knee. I couldn't see his elbow.
And he keeps running.
So Jared Barber comes up, pops him. I think that's Mickey Mouse to call that penalty right there, given those circumstances, especially with the offensive player proceeding downfield.
Arizona State will certainly take it. They'll get the first down at the 42-yard line. Inside handoff to Kalen Balazs, who stuffed right at the line of scrimmage. And that's pretty much how it's been for Kalen today. Not a whole lot of room to run between the tackles.
Kalen, DeMario, Richard. Every once in a while they get DJ Foster and sacrifice him in the run game. Because right now the Mountaineers have been dominant tackle to tackle versus the rush.
Second down and 10. Richard with 48 yards. Balazs, 16 yards. Here comes an all-out blitz. Batted in the air, it's incomplete.
See them. Once again, pressure doesn't always have to get home. As long as you're able to collapse the pocket into a quarterback's face, get your hands up quickly. One of the teams that are committed, competing for a national championship. Alabama Crimson Tide, they're an excellent pressure team, but they do a good job getting their hands up. The pass defender. Another third and long for Arizona State. As we've mentioned, both teams struggled on third downs all night.
Another all-out blitz. Wide open receiver. Pass is caught. Chambers turns the corner to the 30. Cuts it back. 10-5. Touchdown. Arizona State has the lead. 58 yards.
He's able to make it downfield without stepping out of bounds. See Drayvon Askew Henry. He's trying to get him out of bounds. It looked like he was able to do it. See him there? No question. He's clean all the way down the sidelines. That's the easiest one we've seen all night.
Chambers, his second touchdown reception of the year. Fourth touchdown pass of the night for Berkovici, and he goes over 400 yards through the air. 418. The shootout in the Valley. Arizona State up 42-36, and it's getting late. And in the ESPN app. You know, we were in Alabama right after they lost to Ole Miss in that game where they turned it over five times, and you just kind of had that feeling. Nick Saban didn't seem too, I guess, bummed out maybe is the phrase. He still had a lot of confidence in that team.
You mean he didn't think that the dynasty had ended?
No.
Everybody said the program was over.
Right.
This is it. Here comes the decline.
Well, let's go back to that touchdown that's given Arizona State the lead.
Similar pressure that they brought before. K.J. Dillon is going to blitz, as are the linebackers, but this time they don't get home, and he's got a free run to Drayvon Askew Henry, and watch him slip down. See him on the ground right here? That's why he's so wide open. Yeah, guys, we talked about the turf tonight. I don't think it had anything to do with the footing. He just was unable to come out of his back pedal. You brought pressure. The pressure doesn't get home. You got a slot receiver with a free run at your safety at 20 yards deep.
Skylar Howard trying to chase down 500 yards passing, has 480, but will keep it on the ground here. Howard out over the 35. He'll have the first down at the 37, a dozen yards on the ground.
just a matter of time before Skylar Howard got in there. He tried a quarterback counter earlier in this game. He's West Virginia's third leading rusher. Been quiet tonight in the ground game because he's been doing all his damage with his arm.
Boy, well behind Gary Jennings. Let's go downstairs to Casey.
Well, Dave, as you can imagine, there's a lot of frustration down here on the West Virginia sidelines. But K.J. Dillon came over to the group and said, hey, guys, it's time to work. Pick your head up. This game is not over. I'm sick of seeing people with their heads down. Let's get this energy high. Let's go out and let's finish this game.
Well, they've got 4:31 to finish the game. All three timeouts. Wilson Smallwood in motion. Come the way this way with the football. Smallwood breaks a tackle, gets it to the 40. Picks up four, so now you're looking at third down and six.
We've seen West Virginia twice tonight convert longer third downs than this in the ground game. Wendell Smallwood in the offense.
Wide side. Flag is down on the near side. Pass is caught by Jordan Thompson. A gain of 20, but let's see what the flag's all about in front of the West Virginia bench.
Field judge with the flag. Some wholesale changes once again for the West Virginia wide receiver corps.
Illegal substitution, defense, penalties declined. Results of the play is a first down.
Boy, a big gainer on third down. We'll move the ball to the 40-yard line of Arizona State.
See Dana Holgerson in there now, just substituted David Sills in there, among others, in his wide receiver core. Here's Sills right here at the bottom. We've seen them take some shots on deep post. They missed on a number of occasions.
Boy, they send Sills on that post and come underneath with shorts. He'll pick up 14, move the chains again.
That time a well-thrown ball by Skylar Howard. Seen a couple of errant passes. He's taken some shots here in the second half. An unbelievable game as a passer, but he has been injured at times.
518 yards passing now for Howard. Wholesale blitz. Was he outside the tackle box? Did he get past the line of scrimmage? All those elements being discussed right now.
There is no intentional grounding. The quarterback was outside the pocket. The ball made the line to gain. Second down.
Skylar Howard pressured again, eighth time. Arizona State's able to get there.
Ooh.
Man. I mean, he slid in the pocket. I don't know if he would have been outside of it, though. Reviewable call.
Second down and 10. 3.5 to go. Howard. Drop. Lost the football. West Virginia falls on it. Clock continues to run. A loss of a dozen. Longino forced the fumble.
Been quiet all night as Antonio Longino finished the season. Back-to-back Players of the Week honors. Watch him run the arc. That time, wow.
Smallwood almost took it to the house. Well,
one
way to go.
Yeah. He'd have gotten tackled, surely.
Third down and 22. They'll go with Smallwood. Cuts it back. Big hole. Wendell Smallwood. First down at the 15-yard line. He picks up 24.
The third time tonight that West Virginia has converted third and long. Twice third and 10 plus. Wendell Smallwood able to get downfield.
That'll stop the clock with 2:25.
See that time, Gary Jennings, we mentioned earlier, Dave, these receivers have been largely on the same page as their quarterback. That time, Skylar Howard wondering what happened on the fade to the corner.
pass is caught. Touchdown, West Virginia. David Sills, 15 yards. Mountaineers have tied it up.
Quick play action. You see again, just like on the Arizona State touchdown. That time, Lloyd Carrington slipping down, coming out of his break. Two freshmen, David Sills, they targeted him on a number of occasions tonight, and they barely missed making the completion. That time, with the red zone reception, able to get in the end zone.
And the Mountaineers have taken the lead 43-42. Skylar Howard has gone for 532 yards and 5 touchdowns.
See it baked to Russell Shell. See right there, Carrington, that was on the ground. David Sills just needed to make that reception, turn and get upfield quickly.
Go back to the second quarter, and this is a key play in this game. A point after that was scooped up by Tim White. Taken back 90 yards for 2 points for Arizona State. And that's a big play because otherwise you're looking at a 44-40 game, and a field goal can't win it for you if you're Arizona State. Now it can.
Oh, it's huge. It could not have been a bigger swing of events. Keep in mind as well, on the heels of that, West Virginia was looking to squib a kick through the front line. They ended up giving Arizona State the ball at midfield. Sun Devils were able to drive down, pick up a field goal. Ended up being what was effectively a 6-point swing right there at the end of the first half.
Last game for Mike Mercovici in an Arizona State uniform. He would love nothing else. And to close it out, will come from behind victory right here in the Motel 6 Cactus Bowl. 2:19 on the clock. Josh Lambert will kick it off for the Mountaineers. Tim White is deep, but they will just pooch it. And what a dangerous kick we have seen this time and time again. Around the far side, taken by Gump Hayes. And now Mercovici doesn't have a whole lot of ground to make up to get in field goal range.
Once again, really, it's been Arizona State's special teams here tonight. They've done an excellent job in the return game of setting up their offenses. They've had a couple of short fields with an interception, but good job there giving their offense a good starting spot.
Fans, tune in to ESPN3 for the postgame trophy ceremony presented by Capital One immediately following the game. 2:12 on the clock. Sun Devils with two timeouts. Remember, they had to burn a timeout on a kickoff because they didn't have the right alignment. First and 10, Mercovici going down the far sideline. Incomplete. Looking for Lucian. Mercovici's had a heck of a game, too, throwing, especially considering the first quarter when it just didn't go well for anybody wearing a Sun Devil uniform. But he is 29-48 for 418.
He's done it largely with little to no help from his ground game. You see Manny Wilkins come in every once in a while at quarterback to give him that zone read element.
He had 950 yards of passing offense tonight. Valage on the ground, breaks a couple of tackles, gets it to midfield. That'll be real close to the first down line. I think they'll move the chains.
Right on cue. I've mentioned the running game twice tonight and how it hasn't been there. And the Sun Devil backs able to find a way to get some ground game going for their offense.
Mercovici. Stops the clock with 1:44 to go.
That time, pressure being brought by Wachuku. 97, able to slip in there and flush Mercovici off of his spot. See, forced a second and long. This one keeping in mind that they got the ball near midfield to start this possession.
Play clock at 7. Berkovici going deep down the middle. Incomplete. Looking for DJ Foster.
That time, DJ Foster. Yeah, Shaq Pettaway running underneath that route, but it was Jeremy Tyler coming over the top with the help deep, able to break up that pass. Nice protection all day long that time for Berkovici to deliver downfield for a four-man rush.
Third down and 10. Right at midfield. Berkovici. Tim White just flat out dropped it. He would have been 5 yards shy of the first down anyway.
This ball would have been completed. As you can see there, Rick Rumpf driving on the ball. But Tim White, though, we've seen capable of breaking tackles and getting upfield. Give him the ball in space like a return man. But this is the fourth down. Let's see West Virginia. We're going to take a look at this.
West Virginia, their first of the half. 30 seconds.
Fourth down and 10. West Virginia calling the timeouts. Arizona State on fourth downs this year, 10 out of 17. What a crazy game. What a way to finish the bowl season.
It's been nuts, but in all the right ways, right? Offensively.
Here are some Motel 6 Cactus Bowl records that have been broken tonight. Skylar Howard with the 5 touchdown passes, the 532 yards through the air. Most combined passing yards, most combined field goals.
I mean, if these teams were better in the red zone,
the scoreboard
would have exploded. I mean, it's been nothing but up and down, up and down. They just can't get it done inside the 20s.
A fourth down and 10. Over the middle, incomplete, and West Virginia will celebrate. A flag is down, however, back at the 30-yard line, so hold on for a moment. Hold on for a moment.
The ball was tipped.
Ooh.
Looked like Jared Barber from his linebacking position was able to tip that football. I don't know. I wonder if they're getting a chance to look at it a couple more times. I'm wondering if this isn't a targeting call.
There's no foul on the play. Really on the field is an incomplete pass. The ball's turned over on downs. First down to 10, West Virginia.
It's interesting that the flag came out. I'm not real sure what that flag would have been for.
Well, West Virginia had to stand up on that drive. Arizona State on fourth and 10 went down the middle. Tipped ball by Jared Barber. What a shootout tonight inside Chase Field. Howard will pick up 4 yards. Arizona State will they use a timeout? They have 2 remaining. And they will use it right there. frustrating finish for Mike Berkovici's career. Had a fabulous season, but will end on a sour note. You see the frustration. The Pac-12 Football Scholar Athlete of the Year just couldn't make the play down the stretch. Time now for tonight's Capital One Player of the Game, Skyler Howard. A Cactus Bowl record 532 yards through the air and those five touchdown passes. What a night.
It's been unbelievable. He showed some grit, too, in this game.
And he will pick up the first down, and we go under a minute.
And look at Dana Holgorsen. Vindicated in some ways, I think. He's been kind of hung in that seven-win season mark since they've gotten into the Big 12.
He says to us in our meetings, three things needed to occur. We needed better timing with our wide receivers. Our O-line needs to be better, and our quarterback needs to have confidence. How do you think that checklist went?
I think it went pretty well. You know, you look at Skyler Howard. If he didn't have confidence today, I don't know what confidence looks like. They protected him early. I think that was the big part of it. Let him know that, look, we can keep you clean. He took shots, make no mistake. But Arizona State, they're bringing 5 and 6. Loading box with 8 guys. Maybe the difference in the game is how West Virginia protected early.
Lead change after lead change after lead change. But in the end, as the clock hits zero, West Virginia holds off Arizona State in the Motel 6 Cactus Bowl. 43-42 our final score, as West Virginia finishes up the year 8-5. Arizona State goes to 6-7. Let's go downstairs to Casey.
Coach, what a crazy game. So many lead changes, such an offensive game, but your defense came up with a big stop in the end. What did you see from those guys tonight?
Well, you can't win a bowl game unless you're playing okay on all three sides of the ball. It's like I said at halftime, you know, we're playing all right on all three sides. We just had to come together, and we did in the fourth quarter.
What a night for your quarterback in Skyler Howard. What can you say about his performance?
He played his tail off now. I mean, he's taken some criticism throughout the year, and he didn't flinch. You know, he means a lot to this football team. He had a great month of practice. He came out here and he played his tail off. I was really proud of him.
A lot of emotion from you on the sideline tonight. What does it mean to end this season on this win?
Yeah, I guess I wanted to win this one pretty bad. I mean, I just wanted these seniors to go out on the right note. You know, they recommitted themselves when we were 3-4 after a tough four-game Big 12 stretch, and finished better than any West Virginia University Big 12 team. I was proud of them. They're a special group of seniors. They're going to mean a lot to us.
And speaking of that momentum, what does this program look like moving forward?
We're going to keep plugging away. We're going to be in year 5 in the Big 12. So we just want to show improvement. The last couple of years, we've shown improvement. Expect to make some more improvement next year.
Thanks so much, Coach. Congratulations.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Casey. I think it's a huge step for this program to come on the road into almost a road environment. Let's face it, 20 minutes away is Arizona State's campus. And to pull this off, I think it's a big step forward for this team.
No question. I mean, you look at a defense able to come up with the stops when they needed to. Big on third down. They did a good job in the red zone. They've been good in situational defense all season long. But it was offensively. They had almost 100 yards less than their season average. And in this game, kind of went back to their roots in the passing attack and took those shots. You know, so if you can prove that you can do both, that's a dangerous proposition for this West Virginia offense and a lot of young receivers to build around that passing attack.
676 yards of offense for West Virginia, but the best number was 43 points on the board to 42 for Arizona State. Coming up next at SportsCenter, tune into ESPN3 for coverage of our post-game trophy ceremony presented by Capital One. For Matt Stinchcomb, Casey Smith, the rest of our exceptional ESPN crew, I'm Dave Neal saying so long from Phoenix.